It's been about a week. I haven't watched it. I haven't taken any notes. So this translation will be very rough. So deal with it. You can always make your own. You can always make your own translation video if this one is not good enough for you. Anyway, the title of his speech is Getting Stronger Every Day. And it was supposed to be about how he continues to stay on top, how you continue winning, how you continue improving over the long term. So that's what everyone expected. Hello, my name's Daigo. I'm a pro gamer. So before he was here, he wasn't nervous at all. But then he got here and it was so amazing. He began to get very nervous. Title of the speech is Getting Stronger Every Day. And it's also the same title as my book. So the book explains how to stay strong and stay improving over a long period of time. So I think maybe many of you guys were hoping I would talk about that today, but today I'm going to be talking about something completely different. At the very end, I wanted to change the contents of the speech. So I kind of did something a little crazy, and I decided to change that. So sorry, my speech has nothing to do with my book. Please forgive me. Please allow me to speak about what I want to do. Even though a lot of people, they gave me a really nice introduction and how like much of an impressive person I am, but really all I do is play games. So I wanted to just explain, you know, what I'm doing and how I am as a gamer, so please allow me to do that. Anyway, if anyone here wants to go to the toilet, please go ahead while I'm speaking. Me personally, I can never hold it in. I always go to the bathroom, so feel free to go. Whenever I do speeches like this, I always talk about and explain how can you win, how can you improve over a long period of time. That's what I always talk about. But looking at all you guys gathered here today, you guys are all professionals. You look like maybe you don't need to hear that lecture from me. So I'm glad I'm not doing that today. Yeah. I feel like if I talked about what I normally talk about, you guys would already know it. So instead, I want to talk about something that I think will have some meaning for you guys. Let me pause real quick. If you didn't know, this is at a university, but it's not a, he's not talking to college students. It was, it took place at the university, but it was all businessmen. So everyone was wearing a suit. Everyone was older, a lot of very old people, a lot of professionals. So Daigo, he's done speeches before, but this is his first speech at like this level. And it's also his first speech solo. So he was saying, I'm glad I'm changing the topic of my speech, because what I normally talk about might not be very effective for you guys. You might already know. So anyway, he's changing it. So he says, yeah, the main theme of his discussion here is he wants to teach you guys how to understand and determine your own sense of values and your own will. Decide your own wills, decide your own values. But If I'm going to talk about this, if you're going to understand what I'm going to talk about this, I feel like first you need to understand about me and my life and how I've gotten to this point. So I want to explain to you how I've played games so long and what I think about and what I feel when I'm playing games. And also what I'm thinking now as well. That's how I want to start talking. So the first thing I want to check is, do you guys even know what a pro gamer is? Raise your hand if you know what a pro gamer is. He says not even half, less than half of you know what a pro gamer is. Are there any people here that have never played a fighting game? He said, oh man, there's a lot of people that have never played a fighting game before. He said, I was scared about this, but I'll do a very quick, easy explanation. So a fighting game, there are a lot of different type of video games, like a racing game, a soccer game. Well, a fighting game is a one-on-one fight where you use physical and fighting attacks. So Daigo says, he's a pro gamer, but he's only good at fighting games. I'm only good at fighting games. So then you ask, what is a pro gamer? Pro gamers right now, it might change in the future, but at the moment, pro gamers are just people that get sponsors from different companies. Yeah. It's a player who's sponsored by companies. And that's, they're called pro gamers. In 2010, he became Japan's first pro gamer. That was the start. And now this is like the eighth year. He says it's an industry that's still very shallow. Yeah. Pause again real quick. Yeah, so he said a pro gamer. Pro gamer is just, at the moment, it is someone who is sponsored by a company, but he thinks it's a very young industry, pro gamer. So Daigo thinks, in the future, what a pro gamer is might change. They might have to get a certification. They might have to pass a test. They might have to register, and things might change to be considered a pro. But at the moment, being a pro gamer is just a player who's sponsored by a company. I am Japan's first pro gamer. But I want to explain to you how I got to that path, how I became Japan's first pro gamer. People always ask me in interviews, when did I first dream of being a pro gamer? So Daigo says, it's not a really good question because usually the people asking it aren't familiar with the FGC and pro gamers. So Daigo says he never dreamed of being a pro gamer because it didn't exist, right? He never really thought of being able to play games and be able to get food and money. So he never really dreamed of being a pro gamer. Yeah, so he's explaining just, right, pro gamers is not something he dreamed of being when he was growing up. And he's going to talk about when he first met fighting games. He was 11 years old. About 25 years ago, when he first met fighting games, he was 11. That was during the fighting game boom and the game called Street Fighter.
I'll pause one second. ゲームセンターだけじゃなくなったんですね、そのゲームを置く場所が。で、僕が普段行ってたレンタルビデオショップにストリートファイターが置かれるようになって。
All right, so Daigo said he's 36 this year. His first encounter with fighting games was when he was 11, so 25 years ago during the boom of fighting games, and Street Fighter was the most popular game. So Street Fighter was played in the arcades, but since he was a kid, his parents and his teachers would always tell him, "Don't go to arcades, don't go to arcades." So Daigo would never go to the arcade because he was always told not to. But since it was a fighting game boom, even when he would go to the video store, like the rental shop, he ran into Street Fighter at the video rental shop.
だからゲームセンターに自分では行ってるつもりがないんですが、ゲームに出会っちゃったと、
Yeah,
格
so
闘ゲー
he
ムに。
ran into the game. He said, even though I never intended
そ
to,
の時に、
I ran into the game at the video shop.
今でこそ家庭用ゲーム
So
とゲー
up
ムセン
until
ター用ゲームっ
now,
て、
the game center
専用に
games,
ほとんど差が
the
ないんです
arcade
けど、
games, and the
当時
console
は
games had a
圧倒的
huge
にゲームセン
gap.
ターの方が、性能がすごかった。
And the arcade games were
だか
way
ら家
better
で
than
ファミコ
console
ンやった
games.
り、スーパーファミコンやってる子供が、ゲームセンターのゲームを見たらびっくりするんですよ。
So for me, a kid
ゲー
who had
ム
only
のアニ
played
メー
like
ショ
Super
ンがこんな
Nintendo, once I
に
saw an arcade
動
game,
く
I
ん
was
だ、こんなにキャ
shocked.
ラクター大きいんだっていうこ
Wow,
と
they
でびっ
talk
くり
そ
して、
much. There's so many characters, the
ああ、お
graphics are so
金さえ払
pretty.
えばこんなに面白いゲームっ
Wow, if I
て
pay money, I can
遊ぶこ
play
とがで
such
き
an
るんだっ
amazing
てい
game like
う、
this.
ちょっとこういけないことを知っちゃったような感覚
So
になって。
it felt like
でもそれがま
he
た当
became
時の、
aware of a very dangerous
子
thing.
供の頃の自分からすると魅力的だったんですよね。
Yeah, so it was very like
それは親も学
fascinating.
校の先生も止めるわって。こんな面白いもん知っちゃったら勉強するわけないしなって、子供心にそう理解して。
So Daigo
で、まあ、
understood
親に内緒、親とか学校の先
that
生に内緒
if he
で、
started
そこ
playing
から
fighting
ら、
games, he would stop studying, he would
ゲー
stop
センが
doing
や
all
るってい
だ
うの
because
が
fighting games were
始ま
そ
るんですね。
amazing. So Daigo, at 11 years old, he began to
で、
start
お
going
小
to
遣いと
arcades
かお
as a
金に、
secret. He
めぐ
wouldn't
る
tell
と
his
いうか、もう
parents
と
or
に
his
かく全部
teacher.
ゲームに使う。もちろん親には内緒で、なんか本買ったんだとか嘘つい
そう
て、
he would also
とにか
if
く
he
ゲー
had
ムセ
any
ンターに行っ
money
て、
If he had
ゲー
any
ム。
money, he would spend it all on the
で、
arcade,
そ
but
ういう
he
こ
would keep it a
とを
secret from his parents. He
11
would
歳から
lie and
始め
say he
て、
bought a book. He's like, I bought a book with the money.
13歳ぐらいまで続けていくと、子供の浅知恵なんだけど、単純に練習時間が長いから大人にも勝てるようになりだ
So
し
he
たんです
started
ね。
playing at 11, and up
で、ゲー
until
ム
he
セ
was
ン
13
ター
years
っていうのはそ
old,
の格闘ゲームっ
he
ていう
would
のは
practice a
人
lot
と
because
人
he
の
was a
対
kid,
戦
he
です
had a lot of
か
free
ら、
time. He'd
相手
practice a
が自
lot.
分よりも圧倒的に弱いと、
And
次第に物足りなくなってくるんですよ。
So he'd practice from 11 is when he started up until 13, and he would spend all his money, like I said, he would spend all his money on arcades. He would lie to his parents and say he bought a book or something. And then since he was a kid and he had a lot of free time, he would practice, practice, practice. So by the time he was 13, he said he was able to beat adults. He could take out adults as a 13-year-old. Now he's explaining about fighting games.
だから、これはもう俺は地元を出て、
Yeah, so
もっと強い連中
he
が
was
強い
explaining
大
how
人がい
fighting
ると
games
ころ
are
に
only
行くべきだ
fun
なっ
because it's
て
one-on-one
思うようになって、
and you need
13
to find people
歳
your
ぐらい
level.
から、
So he beat everyone
ちょっ
in his
と
local
電
area.
車に乗っ
So by the time he
て、
was 13,
流行ってるゲームセン
he
ターに行
started
くようにな
leaving
っ
his
て、そこに行
hometown
く
and
と。
traveling to arcades in the city to the popular
で、
game
そこに行く
centers.
と、目立つは目立つんですね。
He
子
said, Yeah,
供
I
だから、
stood
当
out.
時
I was a
13
13-year-old
歳の子
kid.
供が流行ってるゲームセンターにいるなんていうのはものすごく異常な
He said it was
光
incredibly
景でした
rare for a
から、
13-year-old like
目
myself
立
to
つこ
go
とは
と
目
one of
立っ
the
てたんです
popular
が、
arcades because they're full of
でもやっぱ
adults.
りまだ強い大人にはかなわないっていうぐらいなのが、13歳ぐらいの時です。
Yep, so 13 was the big change where he started traveling
で、
into
それ
the
から
arcades.
1年ぐらい経って14歳ぐらいになった時に、まあ、熱意もあっただろう
Yeah, so
し、
from
もしかすると向いてたって
13
こともあったの
14,
か、
that 1 year he
まあ、い
grinded
ろん
like
な要因があ
crazy.
るんでしょう。若かったとかいろいろあると思うんですけど、
Daigo says, I don't know why. It
急
could
に
have been
家
I
庭用ゲー
was
ムやりだし
super
て、
passionate about
大変
it,
な
or
ことに
maybe
ない っ
had a
て、
gift, but I was beating
周りのみん
everybody.
なから、お前もしかして日本一強いんじゃ
そう
ないの
everyone
っ
around me
てい
started
う言われ
telling
るよう
me,
に
maybe you're the
なり
strongest
始め
person in
て、
Japan.
で、自分でもそうかもしれないな、
So then
俺
Daigo
は
said,
もう日
maybe
本
I
一
am
強い
the
かもしれ
strongest
ない
in
なっ
Japan.
て思ってて、その翌年、15の年の時に、メーカー公認のオフィシャル全国大会で優勝もすると。
Yeah, so he went,
まあ、
he
そこで、あ、やっぱり俺がどうやら日本一らしいっていうふうに思って、まあ、名実ともに、日本一に なるんですね。
Okay. So yeah, this is when he's 14. So Daigo's timeline is 11 was when he first met Street Fighter at the video game rental shop. He fell in love with it, started sneaking out to his local arcade at 11. For 2 years, he would just practice at the local arcade and beat everybody. And then from 13, he started traveling into the city to the popular arcades with the adults. And so for 1 year, he would do that, and he grinded like crazy. And he said, I don't know why. He's like, maybe it was because I was really passionate as a kid. Maybe I had a natural gift, or maybe it was because all the support of everyone around me. But by the time I was 14, I was really, really strong, and everyone around me was telling me, maybe you're the strongest in Japan. So Daigo said, maybe I was. So he entered the national tournament, and he won. 14.
で、ゲームの世界だと、そこから先はずっと、まあゲームの世界ですけどね、ゲームの世界ですが、エリート街道まっしぐらなんですよ。もう10代の時はもう勝ちまくり。
So Daigo said, yeah,
俺、人間じゃないんじゃないかって思うぐらい。
So Daigo said, when he was in his teens, he was an elite. He would beat everybody, he would beat everybody. He would even think that he was a genius. Daigo would think, man, I'm a genius.
He says
he doesn't know why. There's a lot of different reasons. He doesn't know why he was winning so much. He said maybe he wanted it more than anyone else. He had skills, but
yeah,
he couldn't win. Or I say he couldn't lose.
Yeah. 生まれはね、青森で7歳
です。Oh, yeah, I remember this part.
で、東京に8歳で出てきて、そこからゲームにこうハマってしまうまでっていうのはずっとクラスのリーダーだったんですよ。話をするのも好きだったし、当時としては体が大きかったし、まあ、力もあったんですよね。だから自然とクラスのこうまとめ役だったんですが、
So Daigo's saying, he's giving a, he said, because he was grinding video games so much, grinding, playing video games so much. He said there were obviously some downsides to that as well. Now he's explaining his backstory. He said he was born in Aomori, which is northern Japan. It's like the very northern, like countryside area. But when he was 7, he moved down to Tokyo. And when he was in elementary school, he said he was the class leader because he was his body was big. He was big for a kid. He liked talking very much. He was good at sports. So he was a very popular and like a leader in elementary school.
13歳ぐらいからいよいよなんかこうバス乗って電車乗ってあいつどっかになんかやりに行ってるぞっていう噂が広まり始めて。Mm-hmm.
But then, by the time he was 13, he started traveling into the city. There were a lot of rumors that started coming around that Daigo was like, they're like, what happened to Daigo? Why is he going out? He became like a dangerous guy. So, since he was so focused on fighting games and traveling, rumors started spreading around the school. They're like, wow, I heard Daigo is riding a bus in somewhere. They don't know where he's going. They're like, wow, he's taking a train. He's a 13-year-old kid. That's kind of rare. But he said since he was so focused on fighting games that the normal conversations that his classmates could have, like their favorite music or their favorite TV show or their favorite band and things like that, Daigo was unable to participate in those conversations. And he said he wasn't interested as well.
Mm-hmm.
So even though I used to be the class leader, Daigo the otaku. Ume has become an otaku. So Daigo used to be the popular class leader, but then he started getting cut off. Because they're like, he's got a strange hobby. He's really strange. He's an otaku. He's weird. But Daigo said he was getting sad. He was getting lonely about that.
Mm.
Yeah. He said, even though I was traveling and doing what I love to do, like I was traveling in the city and playing fighting games and doing what I love to do, the fact that I was losing my friends and like my classmates, he said, it wasn't a good feeling. I didn't enjoy it. So I decided I'm going to try listening to popular music. And I listened to the popular music. And I also watched the popular TV show. But in the very end, it just wasn't for me. I realized it wasn't for me. So then So this is like a young 13, 14-year-old kid, right? So Daigo would listen to the music that everyone in the class liked. He tried watching the TV show everyone liked, and he said it wasn't for me. Like, he couldn't get into it. And then as a kid, he realized, is it really that important? Like, is it really that important for me to get along with my classmates? Like, is it really that necessary to do things I don't like to do to fit in with everybody? He said, I couldn't get the answer. Yeah. He was a kid, so he didn't know the answer, but he had that idea, that question in his head. Is it really important to get along with these people? So now everyone's asking, wow, are games really that amazing? Are games that amazing that you don't even care about like your classmates and stuff and like your future and all that? Did you really have to play that much, Daigo? So of course the games are really fun. But
Alright,
so Daigo was saying that he realized maybe he doesn't need to be friends with his classmates. It's not important. He likes games. So then he says, so you might be wondering, are games really that amazing? Like, are games so amazing that you can just throw away like your classmates and not worry about them? So Daigo said, it is true that games are very fun. Like, I love playing games, but what was really fascinating to me, not just the games, but were the people in the arcades. So he said he used to play in Akihabara. He used to go to a popular arcade in Akihabara. And he said the people there were just as fascinating as the games. So now he's talking about school. He says in school, his classmates in school would ask you a question like, I like this, or I like that, like, I don't know. So something, I like this or I like that. If you just say that, then you can have friends. Like, I don't know, something pop, like, I don't know, Justin Bieber. If you're in school and you say, I like Justin Bieber, then your classmate might say, I like Justin Bieber too. And now you're friends. So that real shallow.
Game center to 逆なんですよね. Yeah.
But he says the game center is exact opposite.
お前の好きなもんじゃねえだろって怒られちゃう。周りに合わせてるだけじゃねえかって怒られて。お前の意見どうなんだ、お前の本当に好きなもんなんなんだっていうのがそのゲームセンターで、言われることだったんです。で、なんて居心地がいいところなんだろうって、自分が思ってること正直に言っていいところか、言えば褒められる。どんなことでも思ってることを言えば、お、なかなか面白いやつだなって言ってもらえるって。あ、こんな空間他に知らないなと思って。で、そこから。
Alright, so this is really interesting. This might not be, this is a very Japanese thing too, just kind of the way Japanese culture is. But so Daigo was saying, like, in school, all you have to do is say something like, I like this, or I like this, and that way you can make friends and da da. It's not like whatever. He said, but the arcades are the opposite. Arcades are the opposite. In the arcade, if you say like, I like this, and it, they'll get angry at you. They'll say, like, what do you, like, stop lying. You don't like that. Tell me what you really like. And they'll get angry at you for being fake. So Daigo said he was shocked. He'd never been in a place like that where he could be himself. He could tell his real feelings, his real thoughts, and he could speak like directly with another person and share their real feelings. So as a kid, Daigo was, he said he was like entranced by that. He could be real, right? He could be real. So he said, wow, I can say what I think and what I feel and get praised for it too. And also they taught him not to worry about, he said, don't worry about like people around you. Like, say what you want, like what you want to do or what you like, say it. Don't just say it because the people around you are saying it. The adults, the arcade adults had this effect on young Daigo.
そっかというか、それからもずっと結局ゲームセンターに行っちゃう理由っていうのは、格闘ゲームそのものの魅力ももちろんあったんですけど。
So he said, yeah, the reason why he kept going to arcades for so long was not just because of the games. He liked the games, but the fact that it was a place where he could say things. It was a place where he could say things only there. He could only say the things he wanted to say at the arcade. That's why he was going.
で、それからもずっと勝ちました。
So then he kept going and he kept winning as well.
格闘ゲームに関しては最前線って言ってよかったと思います。
So he thinks it was.
ところが22ぐらいの時に、まあフリーターでアルバイトしながら格闘ゲームなんとなくやってたんですけど。
So he from 14 jumped to 22, but in between 14 and 22 he kept grinding games.
珍しく同い年が大勢いたんですね。
Pause again. So yeah, so he explained why he was so attracted to games, and then so from 14 to 22, it was safe to say that he just played, like, that was the main thing in his life, was just fighting games. Just he kept going for all that time, and that was the highest priority. So now he jumped to 22. He said he started working as a freeder. So a freeder is someone who just constantly does part-time jobs. Very common in Japan. Like, you work a part-time job, and then you switch, you go to another part-time job, and da-da-da. So he was working at a restaurant, and he said it was really rare because there were co-workers that were the same age as he was, so 22, and he had other 22-year-old co-workers.
自分と同い年。だから22歳が、たくさんいて、自分と含めると4人ぐらいいたのかな。
There were four 22-year-olds.
8人ぐらいのバイト。
There were 8 people at the restaurant, and 4 of them were Daigo's age.
だから、
including Daigo.
自然とその22歳同士で話をするんですけど。
So Daigo was naturally able to talk with people his own age.
自分とは全然生き方も違うし、
But they're a bit different from him. Like they're
話をするっていうのは面白いなって。
Yeah.
ゲームセンターっていうのは基本的には年上ばっかりでしたから、yeah. たまには同世代と自分と全然違う生き方してきた同世代と話をするのも面白いなって思いながら。
All right, so he was talking all the 22-year-olds at his restaurant. So Daigo said since he'd been going to the arcades for so long, he was used to hanging out with older people. And now he's hanging out with people that are the same age as him. And they all had a very, very different, like, mindset. They all had different ways of, like, acting and talking and everything. So Daigo was not used to that, but he said it was really interesting. He's like, wow, it was really interesting change of pace to, like, get along with people that are my age.
珍しく長く続いたバイトだったんですよ。
And it was also a job he worked for a pretty long time. He enjoyed it and he worked it for a long time.
ある時同じタイミングでその3人はそのバイトを辞める。
Uh-oh.
うん、まあ就職ですよね。彼らは大学に行って4年生で卒業するから。でその時に、あ、そっかって同い年で仲良くなれた気がした。同じ仲間のような気がしてたけど。俺だけ違ったな、そういえばって気づかされて、みんなはその自分の人生のこうレールに乗る途中でそのアルバイトをしてただけで、俺みたいにどこに行くんだかもわかんない、何するかも決まってない。
Ouch, that hurts. So, the four, like the four young people, the four musketeers, right? So Daigo and the three others. So Daigo said he got along with the other three. It was like a refreshing change of pace having like three friends his age, and they all got along, and they worked that part-time job for a long time. Not like a super long time, but longer than he worked other jobs. But then at the same timing, the three friends, they all quit together. They all quit together, and they left Daigo behind. So the reason why they quit was because they were all university students. They were all fourth year university students. So they were going to graduate and then get their careers and their real jobs. So Daigo said that he felt hurt. He felt hurt because, this is kind of deep, but he said like, my friends from the job, they were just stopping by. He's like, they were just stopping by at the job. Like their life is going on a track, and the part-time job was just like one stop on their life. So Daigo said, I felt like we were getting along and I felt like we related, but then I realized I was different from them. All those three guys had somewhere to go, but only me. I was the only one who had nowhere to go. Like my life had no direction and I was just left behind. So Daigo said he felt hurt right there. He said, yeah, I was different from them. So yeah, he was hurt by that.
あまりこう将来のことを深く考えない僕もさすがにちょっと不安になったんですね、そのタイミングで。
So then, even though he said, yeah, so that was kind of a wake-up call for Daigo. Daigo said he never really thought about the future. He never really thought about his own future up until 22. He never worried about it. But after that incident, he said he became a little anxious, a little uncertain. And he said, uh-oh, this is dangerous. I need to think about my own future.
で、そこから必死になって、今から俺にできることってなんだろう。学もないぞ、資格もないぞ、人とのコミュニケーションもあんま得意じゃないぞとか、いろいろ考えて、で、結局麻雀の道に進むんです。
So Daigo's kind of, so Daigo's really nervous and really anxious. He said, well, what the hell can I do? I don't have any education. I don't have any certification, any qualifications. I'm not good at talking to people. Like, what option is there left for me? What can I do? So then I decided to enter the world of Mahjong, which is not a, it's not a good place.
Mahjong の話っていうのは、過去のその本とかでも結構書いてあるので、まあここでは省いて。で、その道中でした仕事とかも、今日はあんまり話をしなくてもいいかなと。
So yeah, he said he wrote a lot about his mahjong life. Hold on one second. He wrote a lot about his mahjong life in the book. What does he tell me rip for? Oh, no, it's different. All right, good. Anyway, he said he wrote a lot about of the, his mahjong life in the book, and it was in the past, and this is a business meeting, so he shouldn't talk about mahjong because it doesn't help. Mahjong doesn't help what he's trying to talk about. So he said, if you're interested...
介護の仕事をするんですね。で介護の仕事をする
時に、 So then after the mahjong, he said, read the book if you want to see it. After mahjong, he worked at the nursing.
なぜ介護の仕事をする、しようと思ったかっていうと、
So why would I get into the nursing industry after that?
ずっと格闘ゲームっていう勝負の世界で生きてきて、その後は麻雀ですよね。
So he
勝った負けたなんですよ、僕の人生の半分以上は。でもそのどうすれば勝てるのかとか、そういうことも子供の頃からやってるから、もう分かったよっていう感じなんですよ。もう勝負ってこういうふうにやればいいんでしょって生意気な言い方ですけど、そういうのももう思っちゃってて、でもそんな勝負なんて勝ったって別に人生全然良くなんないじゃんっていう、ちょっとこう疲れてるような、感覚がその頃にはあったから、そういう勝負がないな、勝負をせずに生きていけるような仕事がしたいなと思って。
All right, so Daigo played fighting games, and then he went into mahjong, and then he went into the rehabilitation or like the nursing, whatever. So he said, why did I go into the nursing industry? Like, why did I get involved in that? And he said, well, my whole life, like half my life up until that point had been a battle, right? It'd be in a contest, win or lose, because, you know, gaming and mahjong is competitive, right? You always have to win or lose. So Daigo said he was good. He was good at, like, all the competition. So he was very brash and, like, he knew how to win. Like, he knew how to win. But the thing is, even when he would win, it wasn't actually good for his life. Like, if you win, like, a fighting game tournament, maybe that's good. You won, but it doesn't really help your life out. So he said he wanted to try living without any, like, living a life without any battles, without any competition, where it didn't matter if you won or lost. So that's why he got into the nursing. Also, his parents were related to the industry. So they helped him out with his influence, and then he got into the nursing. He really loved it. He really loved, just like he imagined, he loved working the nursing. There's no winning or losing. He said, wow, doesn't matter if I win or lose, I can still help people out and get money. So this is amazing. Doesn't matter if I win or lose, I can help everyone out and I can get paid for it. He really was impressed by the nursing job. He was very thankful and grateful for that.
そんな生活を、まあしばらく続けてて、ああ、一生続けるかどうかわからないけど、ようやく普通の人になれそうだな、勝負がないとダメな人間だった、勝負のもう中毒ですよね、勝負中毒、勝負がないともう生きていけそうだなって、こう人生、そういう意味では人生希望を持ち始めてたんですが、 そのタイミングで、久しぶりにそのストリートファイターっていう格闘ゲームの新作が出ちゃうんですよ。No,
no. All right. So Daigo said, so he was doing the nursing, and he kept doing the nursing for a decent amount of time. And he said, finally, like finally, after continuing the nursing, he said, I didn't know if I was going to do it for the rest of my life, but I felt like I was finally becoming a normal person. I was finally becoming a normal human being. He said, up until now, like, I was so focused on competition and battling. He said, it's like a disease. It's like poison. He's like, I was poisoned by the need for competition, but I felt like I'd finally gotten over that. And I was becoming a normal person who could live a life without having to worry about that. But right when I was reaching that point, the new version of Street Fighter came out.
So
right there, all my friends were saying, new Street Fighter's coming out, new Street Fighter's coming out. I said, huh?
Mm-hmm.
So Daigo was saying, man, I really did used to love Street Fighter.
Yeah.
So when the new Street Fighter 4 was coming out, his friends were like, hey, new Street Fighter, new Street Fighter. And Daigo at first was like, oh, really? I really, like, he remembered how much he loved fighting games and how much he loved Street Fighter growing up. But then he remembered how addicted to the games he was. And he said, I don't want to go back into that life of where everything is a battle. So in the beginning, he said no, he didn't want to play. He turned all his friends away for Street Fighter.
だけど当時若い22ぐらいの時ですよね。もう介護やってる頃ってのは27ぐらいですから、だからかれこれ4、5年前ぐらいに一緒に遊んでた人が久々に新しいタイトル出るんだから一緒にやろうよってしつこくしつこく誘ってきて、
No, it sounds like a drug dealer story. So he said from 22 was when he quit fighting games. Like the story about him at the restaurant where his coworkers all quit. So from 22 to 27, Daigo hadn't played games. But he said all of his old friends from back when he was 22, like the fighting game friends, they kept bothering him. They were really persistent. They're like, come on, Daigo, come on, come on, come on, come back. So finally, Daigo gave in and went to the arcade. He said it was so long. It was like 5 years he didn't play fighting games at all. Like he hadn't touched them in 5 years. He went to the arcade and he was winning. He's like, I was winning. I was able to win. Like I was winning. Daigo's like, I thought I was a genius.
ブランクあったんですよ。2年とか3年ぐらいはブランクあって、まあ、もちろん全く触らないってことはなかったですが、当時の若い頃の取り組みからすれば、10分の1以下、もっとかな、もっとやってなかったと思います。だから完全にもうブランクって言っていいと自分では思ってて。
So he said there was a blank. There was like a gap where he did not touch games. こういうキャラクターを動かしたいな
とか、こういうふうに勝ちたいなっていうのが。そのまんま画面の中で起きる現実になっていくんですよ。
So he said, like during that gap between 22 and 27, it's not that he didn't touch games at all. He said you call it a blank, about 2 or 3 years where he said he was playing like less than 10% of the way how much he used to play. Like he would occasionally touch, whenever. But it's fair to say that I just was not playing games.He's like, but even after that gap, even after that blank, I came back and he said, fighting games were, he's like, if I just imagine something or I imagine a movement, it happens in the game. Like, he's like, I can make things a reality, like with my ideas in the game.
で、22の時にそのアルバイトの仲間が辞めるのを機に格闘ゲームに対しての気持ちが離れて、それから先っていうのはずっと自分の弱点と向き合って生きてたんですね、自分の長所と短所っていうのがあるとしたら短所しか見ないで生きてるんですよ。というのはゲームに全てを捧げてたから、そんな人間がゲームやらないってことはもう短所しかない。
Okay, so he said from when I was 22, when all my friends quit the restaurant job and I stepped away from fighting games. He said, I was living a life where all I was doing was facing my weak points. He's like, all I was doing was living a life facing my weak points. He said, pretty much my only skill, like I put all my skill and all my effort into fighting games. So if I throw away fighting games, all that's left for me are things that I'm bad at.
だからどこの仕事は行ってもお前なんでそんなこともできないねって。So whatever
job I was doing, people would always ask me like, "What's wrong with you? You can't do that."
前株でって言われた時に、株ってどうやって書くんですかって言って怒られちゃうとか。
People get angry at me for all the mistakes I would do at job as like trying to live like a normal person.
何かをこう普通に働くなんていうことがもう本当に大変で、まあバカなことしたなって。要領悪いなりにあの時。中学校の同級生と一緒になって勉強してりゃもうちょい楽に生きれたのにバカなことしたなってゲームなんて何年もたたないことやってってこう思ってたんですよね。
So Daigo at that point was when he gave up fighting games and he was working, he began to regret his life decisions because he couldn't do anything. His bosses and his coworkers would always get angry at him. They're like, "Well, you don't even know how to do that. Like, you can't even do that. Like, what's wrong with you?" Like, you're so slow. Like, what's your problem? So Daigo realized how difficult it would be for him to work, like, and live a normal life. And he was regretting it. He said, man, if only I'd studied, I studied with, like, my classmates, if only I'd worked harder in school, like, I did a really stupid thing by playing video games.
Daigo's job is not a win-lose, but it's not.勝ち負けないって言ったって、
so、when
あいつなんかどんくせえなっていう空気はあるじゃないですか。
He's like, and when I was working in rehabilitation, everyone was kind to me. It's not like a competitive thing, but everyone kind of knew that I was kind of slow.
まあこうやって生きていけるってのはありがたいなと思いつつも、so、なんか悔しいな、男一人の男としてなんか悔しいなっていう気持ちがあって、
So Daigo was happy that he could work there, but it was all, he was still kind of suffering. It was still painful that he wasn't good at anything.
Daigo
said he had a very dark mindset. At the time, he thought he was a failure. Like he said, it's too late, right? I'm a failure. When I was a kid, I messed up, I failed, and there's nothing left for me. Like, I have to just deal with what I've done, and I'm just gonna have to keep doing these jobs for the rest of my life as, you know, a loser.
で、そんな自分が久々に格闘ゲーム触ったら、スーパーマンみたいに動くんですよ。で、その時に、ああ、やってもいいかなって。格闘ゲームずっと、かたくなに、俺は格闘ゲームは真剣にやるもんだって、こうみんなに強がって言ってたんだよね。だから十分に練習できないんだったらやるもんじゃないってこういうふうに言ってたんですけど、で若い頃は周りはね、お前格闘ゲームなんか上手くて何になるんだってこういうふうに言ってたけど、それでもちょっと期待があったんですよ。もしかしたらたかがゲームだけど人と人との勝負だから、ずっと勝ってりゃ誰か注目してくれんじゃないかなって、こう甘い期待があったんですけど。
Okay, soEarlier, we're talking about Daigo felt like he was a loser, how he couldn't do anything, right? He couldn't do anything right, but it was too late for him. He was like, well, I already, like, school's over, everything's over, I don't have any skills, but he can't play fighting games, so he was suffering like that. But then he went back to the arcade, right, because his friends invited him and he played Street Fighter 4, and he said...It was amazing. After all those years of feeling like a loser who couldn't do anything properly, suddenly I play fighting games and I felt like Superman. He's like, I felt like Superman. Right? Imagine like you spend years doing things you're bad at and then finally you do something that you're really good at. He's like, it felt like I was Superman again, being able to do something good. So I thought, hey, maybe it's okay. Maybe it's okay if I play fighting games, huh? Maybe it's okay.If I go back and play fighting games. So then he said, when I was a kid and I was really strong, all the people around me would always ask me, what's the point? Like, why are you playing fighting games? Like, being good at fighting games, like, what's that going to help you out with? So Daigo said he always had a very naive dream. Like, he always had a really naive dream as a child. He said fighting games are...A one-on-one battle, right? It's a one-on-one battle. So young Daigo thought, maybe if I win a lot, maybe if I win and I can beat everyone, maybe people will notice me. Like, maybe I'll get attention and people will notice me. And then maybe something could happen from that. So that was his young dream.
22まで待ってはみたんですけども、そういうことは起きずに、で諦めて。
But he waited until he's 22. So...He played fighting games up until 22 with that hope that someone would notice him and he could make something out of fighting games, but it never came. So he gave up on fighting games and that dream.
で、27になって出会っても、もちろんそんな動きはない、ゲーム業界に。
Said even by 27.
やるとしても、そんな甘い期待ってのはせずにゲームをしなきゃいけないんだけども、何も取り柄がないまま生きていくぐらいだったら、はたから見れば無駄なことに見えるかもしれないけど、またゲームやってもいいんじゃないかなって思えて、またゲームを3、4年開くんですけどね。
はい。
行ってから始めるようになったんです。
Okay. So, that was his dream of, you know, if he gets good at games, maybe something can happen. So, he played up until 22.Waiting and hoping, and it never happened, so he gave up. And then 27, when Street Fighter 4 came out and his friends invited him back, he went back and he played the games and he enjoyed it, but still there was no such thing as like a pro gamer at that point. Nobody was making money. So his dream at 27 was still like not real. So he thought, maybe I can just play games. Maybe I can just live a normal life, like doing a normal job and play fighting games too on the side, but not as crazy as before, and give up on that dream of, not pro gamer, because there was no such thing as a pro gamer, but that dream that he could somehow make a living by playing games.
でこっちはそういう気軽にゲームを楽しんでるわけですよ。一介護職員がなんとなくゲームをしてるって、ただそれだけなんですけど、周りから見るとそうじゃなかったみたいなんですね。っていうのは結構勝ってましたから、全国大会とか世界大会とか勝ってたから、周りの人間からすれば、あいつどうしたんだよって、あんなに大会勝ってて、あんなにすげえプレイヤーだすげえプレイヤーって騒がれてたのに、なんでいきなり格闘ゲームやめたんだって、不思議でしょうがなかったみたいなんです。特に海外はもしかしたらもう生きてないんじゃないかとか噂も流れてたらしいんですよね、当時向こうではアメリカとかで。
So Daigo was saying he was just playing games, right? So for him, he was just a guy who liked playing games, and he would play games and he would win a lot of tournaments. So for him, he was just doing because he liked it. But the people around him, or like not people around, but other people were really confused, especially when he disappeared for the year, the 5 years. They were saying, why would Daigo, like how come this guy who was winning all these tournaments, all these national tournaments, how come he would just quit out of the blue? And he said there was also a rumor overseas that Daigo died. I never heard that rumor, but he said there was a rumor that he was dead. And he was there's a lot of attention on him from especially overseas people. I guess around then was internet, right?
そしたら久しぶりに新しいのが出たら、まあなんかあいつまた復活したらしいぞっていうのが、まあ今はねインターネットがある時代ですから噂が広まって、で今度世界大会やるんだけどどうだねと、お前出てみないかっていう招待を受けたんですよ。でめんどくさいなって、別に俺そんな真剣にやってないし世界大会なんかめんどくさいなって思ったんですけど、だけど普通にこの先生きていった時に自分が海外に招待されることなんてないぞと、まず間違いなく一生ないから、ここはちょっとめんどくさいと思ってもありがてえから、よしじゃあ受けますって言って海外の大会に行くことにしたんです。
So, all the rumors are going around about Daigo and like where'd he go. But then when he came back, so when Daigo came back in Street Fighter 4, it was big news, especially because by then like the internet era was big. So, all sorts of news sites and there's rumors all around on the internet that Daigo's back, Daigo's back, Daigo's back. The rebirth of Daigo. So. At that point, he was invited to an overseas tournament. I believe he's talking about the GameStop tournament, the one where he beat Justin. I believe that's the one he's talking about. But he said he was invited to the overseas tournament, but he didn't want to go because at the time, at this point, Daigo still was not a pro gamer. Right? He was still working his normal job and playing games on the side, like. He wasn't even all in on the games. It was just a side hobby for him. So he said he didn't want to accept the invitation to go to America because he said it was a pain in the ass. He's like, I'm not even playing games that seriously. Like, I'm not interested. I don't want to go. But then he realized it'll probably never happen again because, like, he's just playing games for fun. He's like, this is probably the only chance. So he said, even though I wasn't really practicing and I didn't really feel like going, I accepted the invitation and I went to the overseas tournament.
で、そしたら、まあ、なんな人生って面白いですね。優勝しちゃって、その世界大会全然やる気なかったのに、まさかの優勝をして、まあ、周りはもう盛り上がりますよね。あいつ久々に戻ってきて、世界大会優勝しちまったよって盛り上がって。
So he said, yeah. And so even though I wasn't practicing, he said, like, good things happen in life sometimes. So he said, even though I wasn't practicing and I didn't really feel like entering, he's like, I won the international, like the global finals. He's like, I won. He said, yeah, even though I wasn't really practicing, I won. And then everyone around me started getting really, really hype and really excited. And he said, Daigo's back. Like, he's back. He won the national, the world tournament. He's back. So everyone got really excited. Yo, Mark. Yo, Mark, man. Mark, man, you here?
やっぱりあいつはちょっと人味違うぞと突然戻ってきたと思ったら優勝したしでどうも噂によるとそういう生活面というか経済的な理由で格闘ゲームを真剣にもうやることができないみたいだとでだけどそういう理由でまたこいつが格闘ゲームを世界からいなくなるのはこのコミュニティにとっても良くないからマイナスだから
Okay, so he won the national tournament. Everyone got very excited, and so he said, after that event, that was when I was approached by my first sponsor, Mad Cats. He said, look it up. There's a company called Mad Cats. So the Mad Cats approach, what Daigo is saying, is that he won, and they notice there's something different about Daigo. There's something different about him that, like, he wasn't even in the scene, and then he came back and he won the huge tournament. So there's something really special about him. But for him to quit the FGC because of, like, business or responsibility would hurt the community. It would be bad for the community if Daigo disappeared again. So Mad Cat said, we want to support you. Like, if you want to keep playing fighting games, if you want to stay a part of our community, then we want to help you out. So yeah, Mad Cats, he said that's what they told him too. It wasn't just for him. It wasn't just for Mad Cats. It was for the community too. Like, if Daigo, like, everyone got so excited for him coming back. They're like, if you leave again, it would definitely be hurt the community. So that was his offer. He didn't say yes or no yet. He said, I was very, very surprised to get this offer. I never expected it.
クラスの友達から、ゲームなんかやって何になんだよって散々言われるし、バイト先でも梅原さんの休日って何やってんですかって言ったら、映画見てますって嘘をつく。 休日どころか平日からこっちはゲームしかやってねっつう話なんですけど、休日は映画ですねとか言って嘘つく。で、世間というか近所の人たちもそういう目で見ますよね。なんかよくわかんねえお兄ちゃんだなって。で、そういうのが全部帳消しになるんじゃないか。俺ゲームやってきたことで報われるんじゃないかっていう気持ちになりました、最初はね。飛びつきたい気持ちでいっぱいになったけど、
Alright, so the Mad Cat's offer came. Do you want to be a pro? So Daigo was struggling with his answer here. So he said, like, in the beginning when he got the offer from, do you want to be a pro gamer? Like, he was super excited. He was super happy. And he remembered, it's like his whole life. Like, his whole life was flashing back. Like, when he was a kid and he was playing games, like, he was grinding games the whole time. Like, he had that dream. Remember, he talked about that dream. And then when he was, when he was at, like, his part-time job, he'd always tell lies. Like, he would play games. He was always playing games. Too much. He would lie to people. He said, when they asked him, what do you do on your holidays? He said, I go watch movies. Or, like, I watch movies. Or, I do other stuff. He would never tell people that he was grinding games so much. So now he finally got the offer. So he was really happy, but he said humans aren't that simple. He thought back on, like, the 7 years, the dark period, the 7 years where he quit or was it 5 years where he quit the game?
いやいや、お前だけどそう言って、ゲーム何年やったんだって。11の頃から数えて22ぐらいまで雨だろうが風だろうが台風だろうが行ったのに、台風の日なんて大したこと言ってないですからね。He said he would go.
Daigo said he would go. So he was excited for the offer, but then he remembered, like, remember he was like depressed in that during that time. So he was saying that he now just giving a little flashback. He's like, well, what did you do? Like, what did you do? You played games your whole life from 11 until 22. He said whether it was sunny, whether it was rainy, even in a typhoon, he would go to the arcade. And he said, why would you go to the arcade in a typhoon? There's no one there to fight. But Daigo felt, if I didn't go to the arcade in a typhoon and someone else did, Daigo said he felt like he would have lost. He lost. He's a nut. No matter what, Daigo go to the arcade.
そういうことが繰り返したけど、いいことがなくて、でその後も麻雀だったら麻雀って仕事としてある、プロがある。だから打ち込めば報われるんじゃないかと思ってやったけど、結局、まあいろんな理由でやめるんですよ。
But yeah, so he like he spent all those years, he grinded like crazy, like he pretty much threw his life away for video games like growing up, and he got nothing from it. And then Mahjong too, like he didn't talk about it in this conversation, but he grinded Mahjong crazy. He grinded Mahjong like crazy as well. But again, he quit. Like he didn't really get anything. He didn't really gain anything from that.
だからもう俺は勝負の世界は向いてると思い込んでたけど向いてないんだなって。
So he thought he spent his whole life always thinking maybe he was meant to be in the competitive world. That's what he lived his whole life thinking, but then he thought, know what? No, maybe I'm not. That's when he started working the nursing job, right? So mahjong and fighting games are competitive, and then he never got anything from those, and like he actually like he got hurt by them, and then he started working in the nursing, and he said maybe I'm not about the competitive life, maybe I'm about the normal life.
そうやって一時的な盛り上がり、熱狂、久しぶりに出て帰ってきたやつが優勝したっていう一時のこう興奮で、お前プロとしてやってみないかって言われても、いやこっちは人生かかってんだよって。そんな散々そういうことを期待して何にも裏切られ続けた業界に今更プロって言ったって無理でしょって言って断ったんですよ。
Okay, so Daigo said he turned down the offer. He turned down the original offer by Mad Catz, apparently. So he said everyone was really excited for him to come back and win the tournament. Everyone was like, yeah, like Daigo's back. Come on. Like, come be a pro gamer, like join the community. But Daigo said, like, no, you guys, like, they didn't understand. Daigo said, I spent my whole life, you know, spent my whole life doing this, like hoping and waiting for the chance, and it never came. Like, it never came. Earlier, he was talking about that dream he had, right? He's like, I bet it all. It never came. And now I'm in the normal, like, I have the normal life. So I don't need that anymore. Like, I don't need that. I don't want to go back to that. It's too late, right? If it happened earlier, he would have done it. But now he's like, now it's too late. No. So he turned down the offer. He said, thank you very much for the offer, but I don't want to do it. Is that Mark? Who is it? Mark, man?
説得を受けてる最中に真剣に考えてどうしようかなって、プロゲーマーなっていいのかなで、まあ今ここにいるってことは結局プロゲーマーになるって決断したんですけど、その決断する決め手になったのが、単純に考えてプロになった時に成功するのと失敗するのも人生2つあって、プロゲーマーにならなかった時に、まあ何をもって成功か分かんないですが、 幸せな人生とそうじゃない人生、両方とも2通りあると思うんですよね。全部で4通りあると。でその時にプロゲーマーになって失敗した時に後悔するのかなって思うと後悔しないような気がする。でもプロになんないで自分の唯一得意なもので勝負しないで、安定だかどうだかわからないですけどね、勝負やらない仕事生き方をした時に旗から見ててうまくいってるように見えても自分の中にはずっとあの時俺チャレンジしたらどうなってたんだろうっていうモヤモヤは残るなって、これは簡単に予想がついたんですよね。絶対後悔を引きずる人生になる。旗から見てどうかは分かんないですよ。プロゲーマーチャレンジしない方が世間の人から見れば立派な人生に見えるかもしれないけど、
That's my favorite part.
俺自身は絶対に幸せになれないなと、途中で気づいて、でよし分かりました、じゃあ一緒にプロゲーマーをやりましょうと。
Okay, so alright. So first, he said I don't know if he's talking about Markman, but he said he turned down the offer to be a pro gamer, right? Because, like I explained, he gave up on that life. But he said, but the Mad Catz people were very, very, very persistent. They kept saying, no, don't say that. Don't say that. Come on. Be a pro gamer. Join us. So they kept, even though he turned him down, they kept asking him, come on. Be a pro gamer. So Daigo was thinking, he's like, well, obviously, since I'm up here speaking, you know the answer that I chose, but the way I was thinking about it, I was really lost, and so I was thinking about my options. So he said there are four options, right? He said, or four possible outcomes. He said, I could be a pro gamer and succeed. I could be a pro gamer and fail. Or I could turn down the pro gamer offer and I could succeed or be happy. I could be happy as a non-pro gamer. Or I could turn down the pro gamer offer and like fail. Have like a normal life where everything goes wrong. So those are the four options, right? So he said, if I became a pro gamer and succeeded, like that would be the best one. But what he realized there were like, between 2 and 3, if he became a pro gamer and failed, Daigo said he felt like he would have no regrets, right? If he became a pro gamer and failed, he said, I feel like I wouldn't regret that decision at all. It would be fine. He's like, but on the other hand, if I lived a normal life and I succeeded and maybe everyone around me was praising me and said, wow, Daigo, you're living a really good life and like you have a really like steady job. He's like, even if it looked like I was successful, me personally, I wouldn't be happy. He said he would always have that feeling of I didn't take the chance, right? I never took the chance of what, like I never took the battle. I never challenged myself in the world that was most suited for me. So he realized failing as a pro gamer would be fine. It would be better for him to fail as a pro gamer than to succeed as a non-pro gamer. So he said, once I realized that, I decided, you know what? Okay, I'll do it. I'll become a pro gamer. And so he accepted the Mad Catz offer.
So 2010
was when he became pro gamer.
ようやくプロゲーマーになるところまで来ました。
He said, finally.
今日はあんまりその…
Said, finally.
勝てますよとかっていう話をするつもりはないんですが、一応そのプロゲーマーになってから、今に至るまでいろいろと失敗もあったし工夫もしてきたので、今まで出してきた本の中で何回も言ってることですが、一応今日もちょっと簡単にその、なんていうんですかね、なんていうんですか、そういうの仕事術っていうんですか、よくわかんない、まあ、大げさであんまり恥ずかしくて言いたくないですけど、どういうふうにプロゲーマーとして取り組んできたのかということを、次は簡単に、お話ししようかなと思います。
Okay, so he said the next part of the speech, so that first part was him just explaining how he became a pro gamer. And then he said, 2010, so it's been 7 years. And he's like, I don't want to say that I've just been winning the whole time. He's like, I made a lot of mistakes. I failed a lot. But he's like, for the next part, I want to explain to you how I continue to keep winning and keep staying on top. And he said, I don't want to sound like, I don't want to talk big. I don't want to sound like I'm a big talker, but I just want to explain. And hopefully it'll help you out with your own like business skills here.
念願のプロゲーマー、まあなるって決めたからにはもうやりますよ。もうプロになって最初の1年目はね、1日18時間ぐらいやるんですけど。That's crazy。少ない日で14時間ぐらい。もうずっと画面とにらめっこですよね。ご飯食べる時とね、寝る時、トイレ行く時以外はずっとゲームやるんですよ。 意味あるのかどうかなんて関係ない。とにかく俺は好きなことを仕事にさせてもらったんだって。これまでみんな人から褒められる仕事してたりとかやりがいのある仕事してて羨ましいなって俺にもそういう仕事があればいいなってずっと若い頃から思ってたから、ようやくやりがいを感じれる自分の特技を生かせる仕事に出会えたと思ったら、もういても立ってもいられなくて
18 crazy. So he said, once I decided, once I agreed with Mad Cats to become a pro gamer, I went all in. Like, I went all in. He said, so the first year when I was a pro gamer, I would play 18 hours a day. He would play 18 hours a day. And then like on some days, like on an easy day, he'd only play 14 hours a day. But he said, whenever I wasn't eating, sleeping, or using the restroom, I was looking at the screen. I was playing on the screen. He said he felt like he had to. He didn't know what the reason was. He didn't know whether it was good or not, but he felt like he had to play 18 hours a day. He said it was his dream from whenever he was a kid. So finally, after all these years, he finally got his dream job, a job where other people were praising him. They're like, wow, people were praising him. People were jealous of his job. Like, he had the best job. He was able to do what he loved to do as work. So he felt this need to go 100% in. He said, yeah, I ended up winning the world tournament that year. So I felt...
Yeah.
So he won the world tournament. I guess Evo is what he's talking about there. So he won Evo, and he felt, what is the word? Redeemed? Not redeemed. He felt like it was worth it. He felt like, I did it. Like the 18 hours a day, it was worth it. I won. It was all good.
目がこのまぶたとこの下のところがずっと痙攣してるんですよ。一日中画面見る見ない関係なく、起きてる間ずっと目がブルブルブルブル痙攣してるんですよ。疲れてるんでしょうね、多分ね。あんまり別に病院にも行かなかったから分かんないですけど、であんまり気持ちがいいもんじゃないじゃないですか。ずっと目が痙攣してるって、あ、体にガタが来てんだなっていうことがバカでもわかる。
So after he won Evo, he said things started to get strange. He said the first sign was that his eye, his left eye, began to twitch. His eye would twitch all day. Like whenever he was awake, whether he was watching the game or not, his left eye would always twitch. It was constantly twitching. And he said, I don't know what the problem was. He said, it was probably stress. He said, I never went to the doctor, so I don't know what the cause was. He says, but even an idiot could tell that it's not a good thing. He said it didn't feel good. It did not feel good to have a twitchy eye.
でも念願のプロゲーマーなんだからやめるわけにいかないってことで、そういうの練習をずっと続けてたんですよ。そしたら今度は顔に出始めて、それまで顔にこうできものとかニキビであんま苦労したことってなかったんですけども、ニキビがうわーって顔に出始めて、 人生初、さすがに気づきましたね。あ、これやべえな。俺の体に異変が起きてるっていうことに気づいたんですけど、 それがなんだって、顔にできものがなんだ、まあ、目が痙攣するのがなんだって、そんなことあの自分の何のために生まれてきたんだろうななんて考えてた頃に比べればよ全然マシだろうって、こんな試練だからへっちゃらだって思ってやる。
So、after the twitch, Daigo said the next sign was his face. So he never really had pimples or acne, but he said he began to get like acne and pimples on his face for the first time in his life. And Daigo was shocked, but he said, you know what? Like, who cares? I don't care. He's like, what was I born for? Like, I was born for this, to play jobs. Like, there's no way I could stop. So he continued with the 18-hour a day practice. He said he didn't care. Didn't care about the eye twitch, didn't care about the pimples. There was no giving up, there's no stopping. He just played through it. He did not care.
練習を続けてた。
Kept practicing.
でもやっぱり自分ではそう思ってても、肉体とか精神は徐々にこう疲労が溜まっていって、次第に勝てなくなっていくんですよね。Mm. 練習時間は誰よりもやってるんですけど、勝率がどんどん落ちていく。格闘ゲームっていうのは、まあ、やらない方いるからちょっと分かんないかもしれないですけど、メンタルがすごい大事なゲームなんですよ。どんなに技術があって知識があっても、精神がというか脳が疲れてたらもう勝てない。
So he kept up with the 18 hours of practice. He said, even though my mind wanted to do it, even though my mind said we have to do this, more practice, he said my body and my spirit like couldn't keep up. It was too much. So let me explain to you guys who don't know about fighting games. Oh, sorry. But he said no. He said, even though my mind wanted to do it, my body, my spirit couldn't keep up. And even though I was practicing 18 hours a day, I was playing more than anyone. I was practicing and working harder than anyone. Even though I was doing that, I started winning less. Like my win rate was going down. Then he says, let me explain to you guys who don't know fighting games, but in fighting games, mental, like your mental strength is incredibly important. Even if you have like all the best techniques, and even if you practice like really hard, if you don't have the mental strength and like the mental fortitude, you won't win.
そんなことは若い頃に真剣に取り組んでた時にもね、経験してたから分かってたはずなんですけど、やっぱりいても立ってもいらなくてがむしゃらにやっちゃった。で、結果どうなったかっていうと、格闘ゲームっていうのはあのレバーってなんですね。あのゲームセンターで見たことぐらいはあると思うんですけど、レバーとボタンっていうのがあって、で今アーケードコントローラー、アーケコンなんて呼ばれてる、まあバッターにとっては、バット、ピッチャーにとってはボールと、グローブみたいな感じで、まあ、要するにゲームをする上で使う必要な道具ですよね。1日つまり18時間触ってるものですよ、僕が。それをね、触っただけで気持ち悪くなるほど追い詰められちゃった。ゲーム画面見ると吐き気するんですよ。わ、見たくねえって、レバー触ると気持ち悪いって、なんだこれって、プロゲーマーってゲーム見ると気持ち悪くなるのかって、だこれじゃ仕事になんないな、当たり前の話だけど、こんなに吐き気してるんじゃ仕事になんない、だけどすいません、頑張りすぎてきつかったんでプロやめますって言えるわけもないし。
Alright, so he said earlier the last thing was about his mental, right? And like mental strength and fortitude. He said, I've played fighting games my whole life, and I already experienced this when I was a kid. I knew how important like the mental fortitude was, and how like taking a break was important. He said, but even though I knew it, I had forgotten. I was too focused, so I ignored it and I kept playing. So the next step for his little like breakdown was, he explained like what an arcade is, like an arcade stick. I'm sure you've seen it. Arcade stick, think of like a pitcher's glove, or like the ball or a bat. It's equipment that a pro player needs. He said, next, just touching the arcade stick, just touching my arcade stick, I felt gross. Like I didn't feel good. I felt sick. He said, just looking at the game, I felt like I wanted to throw up. But He said, this is my job, right? It's my job. I have to play. He's like, but I can't, there's no way I could make this my job if I throw up. Like, if I can't even use the equipment, like, I can't do this as a job. But I couldn't quit. I couldn't tell everyone, like, oh, hey, sorry, I worked too hard. I'm quitting. Thanks for the opportunity. So he couldn't quit, but he couldn't play. He was in a dilemma here.
なんとかして この状況を打破しなきゃいけない。
He said, I have to get over this somehow.
考えた結果、ちょっと待てよって。1日18時間やるのって、誰のためにやってんだ。自己満足のためにやってるなって気づいたんですよ。だって18時間やってくださいねなんていうのは仕事の内容じゃないわけですよ。要するに、スポンサーがにとっていい選手であればいいわけだから、いいプレーをして、うーん、観客を興奮させたり喜ばせたり大会に勝ったりするっていうことが仕事なのであって、極端なことを言えば1日5分の練習でもどんどんどんどん強くなっていくんだったら問題ないわけですよ。
So he said, so he needed to figure out how to like cure himself from this sickness, this stress or whatever it was. But then, so he was thinking, he was trying to think, and then he realized, wait a second, why am I playing 18 hours a day? Like, for whose sake am I playing 18 hours a day? It was something that he decided, like, for his own, he decided it on his own for no reason at all. He felt like he had to do 18 hours a day. He said, my job as a pro player was just to, like, enter tournaments, play well, like, entertain the crowd, and, like, win tournaments. He's like, as long as I do that, it doesn't matter. It, even if I only practiced 5 hours a day, but I got stronger, that's what's most important.
ここのところを履き違えてたんですよね。まあ、そのことに気づいて、そっか、18時間練習しても上手くなるどころか、もうゲームを見たくもなくなっちゃうから、じゃあ自分にとって一番プレーの質が向上していく、ゲームが上手くなっていく、成長していく時間とか練習方法って何なんだろうって、そっから僕のそういう勝ち続ける意志力だったりだとか、今回の一日一つだけ強くなるっていう考えみたいなのが出来上がっていくんですよ。
Okay, so when he stopped to realize that, he said, no, you know whatThis 18-hour a day nonsense is worthless. I need to think for myself. I need to think for myself. How can I spend time most effectively? How can I spend my training time most effectively to improve, to get stronger? He said it was during this period where he was thinking, and this is where he developed his kind of philosophy or his mindset on how to continue winning and how to stay strong.
で、今そのいろんな工夫をして、そこから先、2010年の時はちょっとそれでストレスで体壊しちゃったんですけど、それ以降は、いい成績残し続けてきたって言っていいと思いますね。そういう取り組み の仕方を変えてから調子はいいと思います。で、インタビュアーの人にどうすればそうやっていつも普通はね、1年強いとか2年強いはあると思うけど、どうやったらそうやってずっと強くいられるんですかっていう質問をされたときに、決まって答えるのは、とにかく自分を飽きさせないのがコツだと。
Okay, so yeah, he said, yeah, so the first year he worked really hard and he got the good result, like the 18 hours a day. But he said it's normal. It's normal for people to have like 1 year that's good or 2 years that's good, but...Whenever I get interviewed, people always ask me, how do you stay good for such a long time? How do you stay good? What is the secret for staying on top or staying strong over a long period of time? So Daigo says the answer to that question is don't allow yourself to be bored, right? You have to not allow yourself to be bored.
で、なぜ飽きさせてはいけないかっていうと、当然の話として勝負の世界ですから、その練習っていうものを継続、努力を継続していないと継続して勝つっていうのは不可能なんですね。まあ、それは中にはとんでもない天才っていうのは世の中にいて、努力しないでも勝つってことがあるかもしれないですが、まあそういう人はほとんどいないし、まあ僕は格闘ゲームの世界では見たことないです。ってことは、 継続して努力をする必要があると。で、じゃあ継続して努力するってどういうことなんだろう。さっきの言った1年目の自分みたいに全然面白くない、気持ち悪いけど体に無理をさせて18時間練習したらそれは努力なのかって、それ違いますよね。違うっていうのは1年目で自分自身が証明しちゃってるから。ということはきちんと成長して、自分なんていうのかな、意味のある努力ですよね、自分が前に進んでいる、そういう努力を継続させなきゃいけない。
Okay, so he said, alright, so how do you prevent yourself from being bored? He said, well, first let me tell you about fighting games. So in fighting games, you have to work hard. There's no, even if you're like a talented, even if you have natural talent, if you don't work, if you don't grind, if you don't practice, you won't succeed. Or he said, at least I have yet to see someone like that. So you have to work hard. And the thing is, you have to work hard, but also work smart. So he likened it back to his first year where he's working 18 hours a day. He's like, yes, I was working harder than anybody, but that's not a level of effort that could continue. Like, I could not keep that up, as that's why he destroyed his body with stress. So he's saying, yes, you need to work hard in a meaningful way where you can feel yourself improving.
で、じゃあなんでそれが飽きって話と関係してくるのかっていうと、ゲームって好きなことだし遊びだから、まあ当然楽しいですよね。で、楽しいこと仕事にしてんだから飽きる心配ないんじゃないのってこう聞かれることあるんですけど、まあそんな甘いもんじゃなくって、やっぱりゲームっていうのは人が作ったもんだし、というかゲームに限らず何だって同じことやってりゃ飽きますよね。
So he's like, why am I talking about getting bored or getting tired? He's like, people always often ask me, games are fun, right? Games are fun. Games are something you like. So if you can work playing games, doing something you like, then there's no way you ever get bored, right? Daigo said, no, it's not that simple. It's not that simple. First of all, games are something that are made by people, right? It's something that other people make. And you do a lot of the same things in fighting games. Especially me, I've been playing fighting games since I was 11. He's already played enough. He's been playing fighting games since 11. He's already played enough fighting games for his life, he said, right? He's fine.
だけど、その中でも自分に新鮮な気持ちっていうのがないと、人間前向きにならないんですよね。初心者のプレイヤーとかを見てて、ああ、今ゲームにハマってるな、楽しそうにやってるな、あ、どんどん上達してるな。
Oh, this is a big part here.
で、しばらくゲーセンセンターで見なくて、どうしたのって聞くと、飽きたって言うんですよ。うん、で、何に飽きたんだろうなって思うと、ゲームに飽きたって言うんですけど、これは違うんですよ。ゲームに飽きたんじゃない。成長しないことに飽きたんですよ。変わらない。昨日と今日やってること一緒。だからゲームがつまんないってことにしてるんだけど、問題なのは成長してない自分の方なんですよ。
So that's the clip that got like 50,000 retweets or something. So Daigo said, as a player, as a fighting game player, or just anyone who's trying to improve,He said, the most important thing is to keep things feeling fresh. You need to make sure everything feels new and fresh and exciting. He said, let me tell you a story. So often in fighting games, I go to the arcade and I'll see some new players that are practicing like crazy. They're playing a lot and they're really excited. They're really into the game. But then I go back and I don't see them there. They're not playing anymore. And then I run into them again and I say, hey, what happened? What happened? What happened? You don't play the game anymore? And they said, no, I don't play the game. And I say, why? And they said, I'm bored. So Daigo says, bored of what? And they say, bored of the game. But Daigo thinks, no, they're wrong. They're not bored of the game. They're bored of not improving. They're like, so every day they go and play in the arcade, but they're doing the same thing, right? What they did yesterday and what they did today are the same. So they're bored. He says, it's not the game's fault. It's their fault for not improving, for not developing.
成長が実感できてれば、 ゲームだろうが何だろうが飽きるってことはない。
Yes, if you can keep improving, whether it's a game or whatever you're talking about in life, if you can feel a sense of improvement, then you won't get bored.
仕事の都合とか家庭の事情で やれなくなるってことはあるとしても、飽きましたっていうことにはならないと思います。だから人間が前向きにこう努力を続ける上では、その成長があればいいんですよ。
Yes. So,
成長さえ実感することができれば人間というのは飽きない。
Yes. So said, again, like not only, so whether it's work or whatever, it's not just about you're putting in effort and hard work. You also have to feel growth. You have to feel growth. So if you can feel growth and improvement from your effort, then as a human, you will not get bored. You will not get tired of whatever it is.
飽きないから前向きに努力をする。
And then it's kind of like a cycle, right? It's like a cycle. So you work hard and you see improvement. And then you see improvement, so you're willing to work hard. And then you work hard, improvement. So it's like a loop that will allow you to continue moving forward and just always getting better and always continuing to do what you want to do.
当然上達していって成果は出ると。
Yeah, so again.
僕はこれの繰り返しなんですね、格闘ゲームに関しては。で、とは言っても成長って、そのゲームをやり始めの頃と、じゃあ1年後、2年後、5年後、10年後で、成長スピード同じかって言ったら、そんなことなくて、やればやっただけ成長スピードって遅くなっていくんですよ。まあ、それはそうですよね。もうだって、やり尽くしちゃってるわけだから、今さらどこ成長させていいのかも分かんない。
So this is also very important here. So he said, look, for example, talk about me. So playing fighting games, he's like, your improvement in 1 year or 2 years or 5 years or 10 years. He said, no matter what happens, no matter what you do, your improvement is going to drop. It's just natural, right? The more you do something, the better you get at it, the slower your improvement starts going up or the rate at which you improve goes down, right? That's obvious. So...He said, so you need to think, you have to start thinking like, how am I getting better? Or like, how am I improving? How am I getting better?
で、それを防ぐために、僕がやり始めたことっていうのはメモを取るってことだった。
So Daigo said he began to start to prevent himself and to defend against him feeling like he plateaued. He began to take a memo, like a note. He used to carry a notebook around.
今日はこんな発見があったな。
So today I discovered this. Or today I noticed this. Or today I became able to do this. He had a notebook. He would keep track of his improvements.
Okay,
so he said he would keep the notebook. So he said, maybe I would wake up today, and yesterday I went to the arcade, and I was thinking, what did I learn yesterday? What did I do yesterday? So I would look at my memo, and I would say, oh yeah, I discovered that yesterday. So I felt that yesterday I was stronger than I was 2 days ago.And that today, I'm going to be stronger than I was yesterday. So that would give me the motivation to go to the arcade and continue to learn and continue to improve.
で、さらにそこにこれだけだとね、どうしてもやっぱ難しい。いや、だけど今日発見なかった。今日どんなにひいき目に見ても何の成長もなかったっていうこともありえますよね。俺は僕はなかったですけど、僕はそういうふうに思ったことなかったですけど、ありえますよね。で、それを防ぐために、防ぐというか、成長を実感しやすくするために、意識的に変化をするっていうことを、さらに加えました。
So you said, sometimes though, no matter what, no matter what happens, sometimes you will go to practice and you'll go to train, but nothing, no matter how hard you try,No matter how hard you think, nothing will come from your training that day. He said, it never happened to me though. Daigo said, it never happened to me, but maybe it happens. So to defend against that or to prevent against that, you should try to consciously change. You should try to consciously change things, or you should make it a point to do something different, or like instead of just waiting to discover something, he said actively try and change something.
じゃあ仮に勝率 95% だったとしましょう。自分がめちゃめちゃ強いですね。 95% って、まあ、どこでやってるかによりますけど、もし、日本の一番流行ってる例えば新宿とかで 95% だったら、それはもう世界一強いですね、間違いなく。だけどもしその 95% の勝率のある人が毎日毎日何の成長も感じられなかったらどうなるかっていうと、やっぱりその飽きてきて、で人間というのはこう実力というのは相対的なものですから、どんなに強くても飽きて上達がなくなれば周りの人間に追いつかれて追い越されちゃうんですよ。だから 95% っていうほぼもう理想的な勝率であったとしても、その追いつかれて追い抜かされることを考えると、自分から変化をしていかなきゃいけない。
Okay, so this is deep. So he's talking about, let's say you have a 95% win ratio. For example, let's compare it to fighting games. If you play at Shinjuku, which is the highest level arcade in the world, he said, if you play at Shinjuku and you have a 95% win ratio at Shinjuku, then you are the strongest, you're pretty much the strongest fighting game player in the world, right? Excuse me. You are the strongest fighting game player in the world. But he's like, that's perfect. That's ideal, right? That's what you want to aim for, is to have the 95% win ratio. He's like, but if you have that 95% win ratio and all you do is you maintain it, but you don't feel any sort of improvement or any sort of growth, you're going to get bored. You're going to get tired, and other people are going to start catching up to you. He said, so you can never be satisfied by like looking at the results, right? He said, to prevent yourself from being caught up to and preventing yourself from getting bored, even if you have that 95% win ratio, you have to change yourself. You have to actively be changing and developing and improving. Otherwise, people are going to catch up to you.
うまくいってるのに変えなきゃいけないんですよ。普通うまくいってたら変えないじゃないですか。うまくいってんだからこれでいいじゃないか。
He said, normally, right? Normally, why would you ever change, right? If you're number one in the world, why would you feel the need to change? He said, that's what maybe most people, not just fighting games, but just like in general, if you're doing like a great job, why change? There's no reason to change.
でもそれだと競争が激しくなってくると勝ち残れないんですね。
Yeah, he's like, but if I didn't do that, then I wouldn't still be where I am right now.
周りは誰も気づいてないけど、そのうち対応されちゃうぞ。もしくは真似されちゃうぞ。そうすると勝率 95% が 90% になるぞ、85% になるぞ。そういうことを予想して、事前にいろんなことを調べておくんだね。それで勝率が 80% ぐらいに落ちても、それはそれでいいんですよ。その 80% に落ちることによって、将来的なその高い勝率っていうのを、こう、なんていうか、投資してるわけですよね。80% に下げて、また将来的に 95%、何かあった時のために、準備しておくと。
Alright, so he says, look, if you're at 95% and you don't change, right, you don't change or you don't do anything, then people might start to develop strategies against you, or they might start to copy you, and suddenly your 95% goes down to 90, goes down to 85, it goes down to 80. But Daigo says, going down to 80% win ratio or like is no problem at all, as long as you're planning for the future, right? So if you need to go down to 80 at the moment, so that in the future you can go back up to 95. He's like, there's no problem doing that.
で、変化っていうのは、
as long as you're changing, right?
どこまでじゃあ変化させるんだ。難しいとこですよね。普段の仕事のが10あるとして、全部10変えちゃっていいのかって、そんなわけないですよね。10変えちゃったら仕事、違う仕事になっちゃうから。
Okay, so my computer crashed. We are back. Let's get back to this.
で、変化っていうのはどこまでじゃあ変化させるんだ。難しいとこですよね。普段の仕事のが10あるとして全部10変えちゃっていいのかって、そんなわけないですよね。10変えちゃったらしばらく違う仕事になっちゃうから。でも普段これはここからここまでは絶対にやらなきゃいけないと思ってる作業の中で本当に変えちゃいけないのって、その10のうち全部変えちゃいけないってことってありえるのかな。僕はそんなことないと思ってるんですね。そんなわけがない。そんな厳密な、まあそれは実験とかの世界だったら分かんないですけど、普通の仕事で今ある仕事が 100% 完璧だ、一切変化させる余地がないなんてことは僕はありえないと思ってますね。
So, earlier before the crash, Daigo was talking about the win rates at the arcade, right? About having 95%, and then if you don't change, if you don't improve, you might start losing. But he says it's okay to change, it's okay to lose if you're changing. But how much can you change? For example, it's kind of hard to translate. He says, for example, let's say your best work is a 10. Let's say like your max is a 10. He's like, is it possible? You can't change all 10. If you change, like how much is it okay to change? If you go from 10 and you change all 10, he's like, you can't do that because it'll become a completely different thing. But what is the correct amount of what you can change? He said, I don't think that there's anything. I don't think that there's any like perfect work where nothing can be changed. He says, there's always something that can be changed or improved. That's what Daigo thinks.
っていうか、変化させる余地がないんだったら競争ないですからね。一生安泰ですよね。だって誰もそれを塗り替えられないわけですから。競争になってるって以上は、塗り替えれる可能性が、塗り替えられる可能性がある。でそのじゃあ自分の中で今10あるけど9は今まで通りにやってみよう、あとの1はちょっと自由にやってみようかな、少し悪い結果が起きるかもしれないけどこの1を変えてもそんなに大きな影響はないから、この1をちょっと変えてみることで発見はないかな。
So he said, let's look at it like this. Let's pretend that say your best is a 10. He said, how about instead of, you always do a 10, right? You always do a 10. He says, how about if instead of always doing a 10, how about I just do 9? I go up to 9 like I always do. And then with the rest, I try something new. I do something free. I try something new. Maybe the result won't be as good, but it won't be that different. And with that little bit of freedom, with that little bit of change, maybe I'll be able to discover something new or I'll have a breakthrough. So why don't we try that?
で、やっぱり発見あるんですよ。1変えてみると。
Is it?
なんか今まで知らなかったこと知れたぞ。気がつかなかったこと気づいたぞ。これは僕の中では成長ですから。知らないこと知るっていうのは。
So that you said, and it does happen. He's like, when you do change that one, when you change that one, you do. You discover new things. You notice something new, or you understand something new. He said, and to me, that's growth. That's improvement. Whenever you come to know something that you didn't know before, that's improvement to Daigo.
で、そうやって1割の部分を変化させていろいろ楽しんでるうちに、ある日気づくんですよ。あれこれ、2まで変えてよくね。1だけって思ってたけど、2変えれるぞ。場合によっちゃ3変えてもいいぞ。10が正しい、この10全部正しいと思い込んでたけど、とんでもない、蓋開けてみりゃ3割まで変えていいんじゃないか。こういうことって結構あると思います。
So he said, and while I was playing around, while I was experimenting, one day I had a breakthrough. I realized, you know what? Instead of going 9 and 1 and changing that 1, he's like, how about I change 2? How about I change 2? You know what? I could even change 3, right? He said, I spent all up until now, I always assumed that like 10 was perfect and the correct way. He's like, but once I started experimenting, I realized, no, I can change things around, right? So instead of doing like the 10 normal, he's like, you can do 3. You can try changing 3 things, doing 70% like you normally do, and then just experiment with the rest.
で、そうやってこう徐々に徐々に、変化の幅を増やしていって、知ってることできること、そういうものを増やしていくのが、まあ勝ち続けるために、必要なことなのかなと思います。
So Daigo thinks that is very, very important. So in able to continue staying on top and continue winning, you have to constantly be changing. So whenever you're changing, you become able to do new things, you gain new knowledge, you gain new skills, so you're always improving. So that's the before the crash when Daigo was talking about the forced changing. Changing yourself, forcing yourself to try new things to improve.
ここはちょっとあっさりめでいきます。あの本とかにいっぱい書いてあるんで、もし興味があれば本を読んでくださると。
Again, he's
ありがたいです。
Shilling his book out. He says, sorry, this is a very shallow explanation. I wrote more about it in my book. If you're interested, please read the book. It tells you all about it.
いよいよ今日話をしたかったことです。
Now he's finally...
もしかすると一番興味のない話かもしれないなとも思うんですよ。
So Daigo said, now, earlier too, at the very start, if you weren't watching in the beginning, Daigo said that he changed his, not damn, it's bright. He changed his plan. He changed like the topic of his lecture, right? He changed it. So he said, now we get to the main point. This is what I wanted to talk about. He said, unfortunately, I feel like this is the most boring part. He's like, I don't know if you guys are interested in this, but this is the main part that he wants to talk about.
これを人の前で話すっていうことは初めて。
This is his first time ever speaking about this in front of people.
どういう反応が返ってくるのか。
So he has no idea how everyone will react to it.
普段インタビュアーの人たちに話すことっていうのは反応があるじゃないですか。はあ、なるほどとか。へえ、そうですねとか。
Whenever you,
かもしれないけど。それでちょっと安心して人前で話せるんですけど。今日話すことっていうのは、自分の中で思ってることだし。共感を得られるかどうかっていうのが全然自信ないんですよね。
So he said, whenever you do an interview, like whenever Daigo talks in an interview, it's a one-on-one, and so the interviewee or the interviewer will give you feedback. They'll go like, oh, really? Is that so? So that gives Daigo the confidence to, or not Daigo, but that gives anybody the confidence to speak like about what they want to speak because they get the reaction. But Daigo's talking from the crowd, so there's no reaction. So Daigo doesn't know. He's like, what I want to talk about is my own feelings, and it's really important to me, but I have no idea if it will like affect you guys or it has anything to do with you, but Daigo is very nervous.
まあでもそれでもその時感じたことを話すべきだろうな。
But he feels like it's something that he has to talk about.
自分の中でまず間違いがないなって思ってることだけ話すっていうのは正確に合わないですから、今感じてることを話しますと、
Yes. So he has to talk about it. Daigo is someone who is always willing to talk about like what he feels. So he says not talking about it wouldn't match his character. So he's going to talk about this.
と突然なんですけどね。こんなこと聞くの失礼なんですけど。
So sorry, this is really sudden.
皆さんってあの充実って知ってます？
What?
まあ何言ってんだろうって思うかもしれないですけど、楽しんでるのかな。いやこれはあの。
So Daigo said, he said, sorry to ask you guys this suddenly. Sorry to ask you this suddenly. It might be a little bit rude, but do you guys know what happiness is or like fulfillment? He said jujitsu, right? Like, are you familiar? Like, are you happy? Are you satisfied with your life?Or here, let me change you, or let me change the question. He said, are you enjoying yourself? Are you enjoying life? Are you enjoying... Yeah. And yeah, he just asked, like, are you happy? Are you happy with your life?
楽しんでないでしょとかそういうことじゃないですよ。
Like,
僕自分のことしかわからないから、他人が楽しく生きてるのか、充実してるのかってわかんない。
He says, Daigo says, I only know my own life. He's like, I only know me. I only know my own feelings, my own life. I don't know what other people are feeling, but he's asking you guys.
なぜそんなことを言うのか?
Why am I asking you that?
っていうと、あの、実を言うと、まあこうやって本のね、あの、3冊ぐらい出して、その中で僕は 言ってんですよ、偉そうに。成長できればいい、変化をできればいい、成長が僕の生きがいだって。まあ確かにそう思ってましたし、今でもそうなんですけど、
うん、
これ結構重要な問題で、何のために成長するのかっていうことが自分の中で分からなくなっちゃうと幸せじゃないんだな。
Okay, so Daigo says, I read a lot of books, and like in my books, I talk about, you should improve, right? You should focus on improving yourself. You should focus on getting better. You should, like, the will to keep winning. He's like, I sound like very stuck up. He's like, I talk like very high and mighty. He's like, but I do believe all those things. I do believe in you should improve. But really, what you need to think is, like, sometimes you lose track of why you're improving. So Daigo said, if you lose track of why you're improving, you will lose your happiness, right? Even if you're doing better, if you don't know why, you won't be happy. So Daigo just recently realized that. He's going to say it straight, but for 2 years,
2015年の途中あたりから、あんまり楽しくないんですね、正直。
So Daigo saying straight up, this was actually shocking, I remember this. So Daigo said, I'm gonna tell you guys straight right now. This is in a crowd of 300 people, right? And like 4,000, five, I forget how many people. But Daigo says, I'm gonna just say it straight. So for about 2 years, like what is it? He says 2017 right now. So he says in 2015, I wasn't happy. I wasn't happy. Like, I was not happy. I did not think life was happy or fun.
I thought,
what the hell is wrong with these? Am I stressed out? I would have understood, like, because I am stressed out during tournament season, but even when there were no tournaments, I still felt that way.
歳かな?
Am I getting old?
でも、歳だ、まあ、歳って可能性もあるかな。
Well, it could be. Maybe I'm getting old, but there are other people my age that are going crazy, they're having a great life. What's wrong with me? I never felt this way when I was young. Daigo said he never felt this way when he was younger. He felt that life was boring. Is this all that life has to offer? He says, is my life just going to end like this? I felt that often.
He's
like, I'm not saying that I was like super depressed. I wasn't like super depressed. I could still go to a fun place and enjoy myself, and I could still focus on games, but I always had this feeling in the back of my head that like something's wrong. Like, this is not fun. There's something boring. Like, this is not fun. For 2 years, it continued. But just recently, just really recently, he got over it, and life's been fun again. Okay, so just recently, from 2015 to just recently, he said he'd been kind of depressed and he felt life wasn't fun, he was bored, but just recently he got over it, and he said the reason why was, he said he kept saying he was bored, but he didn't understand why, but he recently just understood what was causing him that kind of depression.
これはちょっとゲームの話になるんですけど。
This part's funny.
He says, so I'm going to talk about 格闘ゲームに限らず、他のゲームでも何でも、今ってバージョンアップっていうのが行われるんですね。
Street Fighter 5.
バージョンアップって何かっていうと、まあ現実世界で言えば法律が変わるみたいなもんです。だからそれまで大儲けできた商売が全然儲かんなくなったりとか、まあそんなもんです。そういうことが頻繁に起きる。1年に1回とか半年に1回起きる。だから有効だと思ってた戦法が弱くなったり、強いと思ってたキャラクターが弱くなったりするんです。
So he said, so recently, he's like, recently, in the fighting game, there was recently a version up. He's like, for you guys that don't play fighting games, I'll explain like a version up. Imagine that the laws changed, like in the real world, if laws suddenly changed. So things that used to think were right are now wrong, and characters that used to be strong are now weak. Characters that used to be weak are now strong. He's like, everything just changed recently. So he's saying, the character I used to use... You guys know what he's talking about, but he said, so if I just give a really simple explanation, the character I used to use became weak this year. The strong character I used to use became weak. So then he said, and then my sub character, if you don't know what a sub character is, it's a character that you play not as your main, but you're familiar with and you can use. He said, well, one of my sub characters became incredibly strong. So what would you do at a time like this?
なおさらそうですね。賞金も今じゃね、去年の一番大きな大会の賞金なんて2000何百万とか。それを取るため1%でも高い確率を上げるようなキャラを使うべきだと思うし、何より勝つということを前提でスポンサーもついてると。で、周囲の期待もあるし。
So he said, what would you do in a situation like this where your character was nerfed and then your sub character became incredibly strong? He said, almost 100% of the people would go and pick the stronger character. He said, especially as a pro gamer, because as a pro gamer, you want to win. And he said, the biggest tournament last year, the prize was like, what was it, 270,000? I don't know. I can never do the numbers, but you know, like the 250,000 Capcom Cup. He said, there's the money, and then there's my responsibility to the sponsor, and then also the hopes of the people around me, like my fans. He's like, I have to answer all of these. So even if it's only 1%, a fighting game player, even if it's only 1% like increase in effectiveness, they should take that option, right? It seems obvious to always choose the option that will give you the highest percent to win, even if it's something as small as 1%. So Daigo said, yeah, so I started using the strong character. And that's...
その病気が始まった。で、原因が分かんないんですけど、その弱かったキャラ、弱くなってしまった方のキャラ、前のパートナーみたいな感じですよね。前のパートナーの方のキャラを使ってみたら弱い、間違いなく弱いんだけど、 子供の頃に感じてた充実感みたいなものが帰ってきたんですよね。で、あれ、この感覚久しぶりだなって思って。で、理由は分かんないんだけど、理屈にも合ってないし、やるべきじゃないの分かってんだけど、なんかそっちの方使っちゃう。So
he said, so I did. I actually started to use the strong character. He said, I started to play the strong character. And don't get me wrong, the character was incredibly strong, but when I played him, that sickness came back. That depression came back to me. I didn't know why. I said, why? Like, why am I feeling this way again? Why am I feeling this depression, a sense of boredom? He's like, well, the character that became weak, the character that I was using who became weak, he's like my old partner. I don't know what it is, but he's like, when I play that character, the weak character, I get a sense of fulfillment that I used to have as a kid. When Daigo was a kid, when like he early explained about when he was a maniac about fighting games, he says, I get that feeling of enjoyment and fulfillment again by playing that weak character. So there's no good explanation, there's no reason, there's no rhyme or reason, but I want to play that character. I want to play that character, the weak character. But why? But why do I want to play that character? I don't know. I can't think.
自分で決めてなかったんですよね。ここ2年ぐらい自分で決めてなかった。周りから見ればあいつは自分で決めてるっていうふうに見えるはずです。実際、うん、立場を考えると相当自由にやってる方だと思いますけど、でもやっぱりこう自分の中に少しずつ少しずつ、まあでもスポンサーもいるし、ギネスもまた受賞したし、テレビにも出たし、雑誌にも載ったしっていうことがちょっとずつちょっとずつ自分を変えていってるんですよね。だから本当に自分がやりたいこと、自分が好きなことっていうのが分かんなくなってきてる。
All right, listen up. So this is important here. This is one of the reasons why I'm doing this. So I see a lot of people in the chat like listen up. I'll do my best to try and translate this. It's not that simple, right? I see all these random tweets or random like event hubs comments that are like, Daigo's doing this. So he's explaining why he's picking this character, because it's so much more than just the game. So he said, I realized, why did I get this sense of fulfillment by playing the weak character? And I got depressed when I played the strong character. And he's like, I thought back to the 2 years, 2015 and 2017, where I was depressed and I was not happy with life. And I realized that for those 2 years, I had lost control of my life. I wasn't making my own decisions. I wasn't deciding things for myself. He said, to everyone around me, I'm sure everyone else who was watching me might have thought that I was living a free life and I was doing whatever I want and I was deciding everything. He's like, but it wasn't like that. For those 2 years, I had to worry about my sponsors. I had to worry about people's expectations, and I had to worry about everyone else. And I lost sight of what I wanted, what I personally wanted to do, and like my original goal, my original motivation, I lost sight of that. And that's why he was depressed for the 2 years.
で、周りの価値観に合わせ始めてたんですよね。プロだし。
That was
e スポーツ。
e スポーツ。
ゲーム業界盛り上がってきたし、勝つべきでしょう。とか、これ何々するべきでしょう。で、その何々するべきでしょうっていう理屈から言えば、今の弱いキャラを選ぶっていうのはとんでもない行為なんですよね。うん、皆さんからすると、なんで勝てない、なんで勝てる方やんないの、なんでわざわざ勝ちづらい方やるのっていうことになるかもしれないんですけど、まあもちろんそのまたね、ルールが変わって、そのルールが変わった時にいかんだけ弱くなってんだから、もうちょっとまともになるだろう、ルールの方がまともになるだろうっていう計算もあるにはあるんですが、仮にそうならなかったとしても、やっぱり弱い方のキャラを使っちゃう。
So he said for the first time in his life, for those 2 years, so like 2 years ago when Daigo, I guess, is 34, he said for the first time in his life he began to try and match what the people around him were doing, right? He began to like listen to them and follow them. So he said, the fact now picking a weak character is incredibly strong. Like to go against what's expected of him and to pick this weak character is incredibly like a strong decision, because everyone is asking him, why are you picking the harder to win character? Why are you picking the weak character? Why aren't you taking the easy way? So Daigo said, it might be true because the rules have just changed. So maybe Ryu's not that weak. I said his name, sorry. Maybe the weak character is not that weak. Maybe after we understand things, he'll become better. But even if he stays weak, I want to stick with the weak character. I want to make my own decision.
これ女性なんですけどね。
So let me tell you a story about my friend. She's a female.
彼氏がいますよね。彼女付き合ってる人がいたときに、常に親から もっといい人捕まえる努力をしつつ付き合いなさいって言われるらしいんですよ。すごいですよね。だから彼氏がいるのに出会いの場には必ず行けって、こういうふうに親が言うらしいんですよ。でお前はお前にとって最高のそのまあ言い方悪いけど条件の男と付き合い、そして結婚しろって、こういうふうに言うらしいんですね。
So Daigo is telling a story about his friend. Is a girl. So this girl had a boyfriend. So she was dating somebody, and then her parents told her, even though she has a boyfriend, said you need to go and find a better boyfriend. So even though you're dating a guy, you need to go out to places where you can meet and find a new guy, a guy who's better, a guy who's better than your current boyfriend. So her parents told her that. Daigo thought that, wow. That's crazy.
教育というか、教育じゃないですよね。
Wow, I can't believe parents would force you to do something like that. That's amazing.
どう思ってんのそれって聞くと、うん、まあでも親にがっかりさせたくないし。
But I understand you don't want to let your parents down, right?
それがいい気がするから。
Yeah, you should try and って言うんですよ。 You should try and make your parents happy. So,
その子の前についに完璧な男が現れたんですよ。東大卒で、なんだ、顔もいいし、背も高いし。でいい会社入ってて、家柄良くて、話が面白くて、食事の趣味も合う。お前ついに出会ったね、よかったね、我慢してて。
So, suddenly that girl who was looking for a better boyfriend to make her parents happy, she found somebody. She found a guy who was a Todai graduate. He's rich, handsome, tall, like good face, like interesting, like a perfect, found like a perfect partner.
すげえじゃんって、それだけの男なかなかもう出てこねえぞ。
So Daigo was like, holy crap, like wow.
うん、そうだ。
Congratulations.
だけど、で向こうは自分のことがどうやら好きだと。完璧じゃんって、お前すげえラッキーじゃんって。
So Daigo was like, wow, wow.
だけど、
amazing. You found this guy.
なんか違うって言われて、まあでもなんか違うって言っても。
But the girl said, there's something off. Like,
哲学から言えば、さ付き合うべきなんだろうと。
But Daigo said, doesn't matter. Like, this is like the perfect guy, right?
しばらくしたら彼氏ができたとかっていう話を聞いて。
So then Daigo heard that she got a boyfriend.
あの例のエリートと付き合うこと
になった。So Daigo thought she was dating the like the.
全然違うのと付き合ってんですよ。
Daigo thought she was dating like the really really like.
うんって。
Perfect guy.
別の人と付き合ってって。何？
Huh? What?
あの男よりも条件のいい男が現れたのって。すごいねって。聞いたら、いや全然そんなことないよって。うん。あの別に。顔も普通で、お金もそんなないし、家も普通でみたいな。まあとにかく、あいつがその見てるその物差しで測ってるところは全部その前のこう好意を寄せてくれてた男より悪かったらしいんですよ。だけどそっち選んだって言って、お前どうしちゃったんだよって。
So the girl found the perfect guy, right? The girl found that perfect guy. So Daigo didn't see her for a while, and then he heard that she got a boyfriend, and Daigo was like, wow, like congratulations, you started dating that guy, you met him.So she's like, no, I'm not dating that guy. And he was like, why? She's like, no, I went for, there's a different guy. So Daigo's like, what? You found the guy that was even better than him? She's like, no, not really. Like, this guy's not rich. He's normal. Normal face. Just, he's a normal guy. Daigo's like, what? And he's like, well, he was good at, like, he was interesting at talking. So Daigo's like, why would you? What?
でもそっちの人の方が話面白いんだよねってこういうわけですよ。
So that was it. He was,
he
was good at talking, and Daigo's like, what? That's it?
That's it?
So even though Daigo was the girl's friend, right? When the girl said she was dating this normal guy, Daigo said, that's it? But Daigo said...He's like, but I realized like when I said that, when I said, that's it, why would you go after that guy? Daigo wasn't thinking about her. He was thinking about her parents.
なるようになるでしょってこういうふうに言われて。その時に、当時はね、気がつ、あんまり何とも、そのことに関しては何とも思わなかったんですけど、そりゃ親の人生じゃないですからね。
It's not your parents' life.
まあ今の僕にとってその弱い方のキャラを使うっていうのは多分その女の子と同じ選択なんですよ。 強くなった方っていうのは全部持ってる。ただ全部持ってるっていうのは人が決めたものですよ。
はい。Listen up, Event Hubs. So Daigo said that it's not, it wasn't like, it's her life, it's not her parents' life. And he said, Daigo said, picking this weaker character now is kind of the same way that the girl picked the boyfriend that she liked. So the strong character has everything, but the strong character, the strong boyfriend, they have everything. He's like, but what is everything? He's like, those are things that are decided by other people. Like, what's good and what's bad is decided by other people.
Like, 顔だって時代が変わりゃよくわかんないし、身長もそうだし、家柄ってなんだよそもそもってよくわかんないやって思ってるし、全部人の価値観だし、時代も変われば変わることだし。
Yeah. So, like, who said graduating from this university is better than graduating from this university? Who said this is handsome? Who said, like, being tall is better than being short? Who said this is better than that? Everything is decided by people around you. And those values are always changing, right? Those values are changing every time period, like every location. Things are always changing and it's always decided by other people.
そんな不確かなもので人に合わせて自分の感情を押し殺すなんてそんなバカなことないなって。
Yeah.
そんだから女の子は賢いなって思いましたね。
So Daigo thought, look, if...Things are always changing, right? What's considered good is always changing, and it's decided by other people. If you're going to throw away, if you're going to lose what you personally think is good because other people say this is good, that's really stupid. And Daigo realized how smart and how, like, impressive that girl was by choosing the guy, the normal guy, right? The normal guy that she liked over the guy that had everything, the guy that was perfect.So Daigo is impressed by her. She's living a really good life, a really smart life. So that's it. Daigo said, everyone's asking me, why am I not picking a strong character? Why am I not pickingthe strong character, why am I picking the weak character? What's wrong with me? Daigo said, well, the reason why is that the weaker character is more interesting to me, and that's it.
でもたったこんだけのことなんだけど、この
But it's not just that.
ずっと退屈だった気持ちっていうのが晴れて、毎日楽しくてしょうがないんですよ。わ、そうや、人生ってもそれ面白い、楽しかったな、面白かったんだな。それまで人の価値観に流されないで生きてきたつもりだったけど、なんかいろいろうまくいって周りからおだてられて持ち上げられて、ああ知らず知らずのうちに合わせて、なんかすげえ人生つまんなくなるところだったな、危なかったなって本当に最近気づいて、でもプロになり始めた時に。
Hold on. So he said, it's not just that. So this character is more interesting to him. But he said, those two years, I was depressed. I was in a really dark place for 2 years. And finally, I recovered. And every day I'm enjoying my life. And life is great. Life is wonderful. And I realized how dangerous of a situation I was in, where I assumed that I thought I was living my own life. I thought I was...making my own decisions, but I was really just kind of trying to meet everyone's expectations and follow everyone's goals. So finally, I was freed from that. So, right, there's no way I could go back. Like, I have to keep living my own life.
ある一つの思いっていうのは実は浮かんでて、最初は感謝だったんですよ。ああ、ありがてえな、俺みたいな、本当に自分の好き勝手やってきて無責任なゲームのもうゲームオタクみたいなやつをこうやって好きなことで生かしてくれるんだ、なんてありがたいんだろうって最初感謝してました。で、物珍しいからっていうんでメディアも注目するし、まあギネスブックに、なんかこう認定されたりとかってこうどんどんどんどん 大人がって言っちゃうとあれですけど、まあ大人が喜びそうなものがついてって、でその時に、
So he says, so this whole situation reminds him of something that happened when he first became a pro gamer. So when he first became a pro gamer, the first year, he was really, really, really grateful and really happy. He was able to play games, and then everyone was noticing him, and the media started writing about him, and he made television appearances, and everyone started, like, focusing. Everyone started, like, Daigo became famous, right? So he's becoming famous. But he had a bad thought. What is this? What is this bad thought? Someone, yo, let's get some Daigo fan art here. So Daigo, when he's becoming really famous and really everyone is looking up to him, he said, I had a dark thought. And the thought was, this is my chance to get revenge. And he said, get revenge on who? You might be asking, who do I want to get revenge on? He's like, on society. Like, oh shit. Daigo Uchiha right here, trying to get his revenge chance on society. But he's like, let me tell you a story I had. When I was 20, I was going to a place called
So
when Daigo, he's telling a story now. When Daigo was 20 years old, he was still a kid. He was still a little kid, right? He was working part-time job. He was poor. He was just a gamer, right? He wasn't anybody. He was just a gamer. No college, no driver's license, no nothing. So he was going to go to a very expensive restaurant. Like, his friend introduced him to a restaurant. So Daigo saved up his money. He was very, very excited. He was going to treat himself to this special. You do that, right? You guys have been treat yourself somewhere nice. So he wanted to go to this Japanese restaurant. So he went to Tokyo Hill, I think is what he said. But it's a very, like, luxurious building. So young, innocent Daigo was very, he said he'd never done anything like this before. He dressed up well. He was ready to go. He was ready to go fit in. Okay, the restaurant was on the basement.
で、その式場の受付のお姉さんに何だこいつはってこういう顔されたんですよ。なんですかって言われて。で、こっちは初めて行く披露だし、こんな田舎者が世間知らずのやつが行ってもいいのかなってビクビクしてるから、その一発目でこっちが間違えたのが悪いとは言え、何ですかっていう顔されて、すごいショックだったんですよ。で、ああってこうやって
So this is more, a lot of people say Daigo's got like a complex, but so again, 20-year-old Daigo, he's from the countryside too. He moved to Tokyo when he was a kid, but he's not from like a wealthy family. So he was all dressed up and he was trying to go to this fancy place, and he was really excited, but he was also really nervous because he's like, I don't know, like, am I allowed to go to a place like this? Like, can I fit in like a nice restaurant full of like rich people and very blah, blah, blah. So the restaurant was on the basement. Daigo made a mistake and went to the second floor. So he took the elevator up to the second floor. So the door opens and there's like a wedding reception. So it's a bunch of people wearing like nice dresses and nice suits. And Daigo accidentally walked in there, and the receptionist, like the first person he sees, is this girl. So the girl gives him a really, like, you see him, you see his face go like that. She like reeled back and glared at him and said, like, what the hell do you want? Like, what are you doing here? And Daigo was hurt right there. He's like, because he was really like young, innocent, nervous Daigo. He was really trying to, he wanted to go experience this. He wanted to see if he could fit in. And right away, he said immediately, the first, as he was questioning whether or not he could fit in, the first interaction was, what the hell are you doing here? Like, get out. So Daigo right away was like, ah, okay. No, like, I don't belong here. Like, I am not qualified to be with these people, right? I'm just a bum. I'm just a fighting game player. Yeah, so Daigo felt bad.
Mm-hmm. He's like, yep. それが何なのか分かんないですよ。人脈なんだか、地位なんだか、何だか分かんないけど、それがあればこんな顔されずに済んだんだなと思って。でも自分の人生を知らないはずだけども、なんか否定されたような気になって、ちくしょうって思ったんですよね。で、それからもなんかことあることにそういう、惨めな思いっていうのはしたけど、プロゲーマーになってメディアに出て、
So Daigo, when he got that look from the girl, he really like took it to heart. He's like, well, I was wrong. I never should have been here. I don't belong here. I never should have came here. I could never fit in here. Da 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 da. But then later he started, so that happened when he was 20. Then he became a pro gamer at, what is it, 27, I think. But that first year when he was a pro gamer, he started getting all these things where, like, things he used to dream about, he started to get them. He just kept getting, like, media bigger and bigger and bigger, and, like, media, and he's getting more money and all this stuff. So Daigo realized, as he was becoming more famous, he said, hey, I could get revenge. Like young Daigo, who was looked down upon, he's like, now I could show these people, right? Get my revenge. Like, I wonder what kind of look I would have got now.
本当にその気持ちがなければ、どんなに周りから褒められ、褒められるっていうか、チヤホヤされようが、こう肩書きが増えようが、自分の取り組みとか姿勢っていうのは変わるわけがない。だけど心のどっかで、今あの受付にいたお姉さん、俺のこと見たらどう思うんだろうなっていう悪い気持ちがあったんでしょうね。おそらく出会ったらあんな目はしてこないだろうなって。
So Daigo wasn't changing himself. He wasn't trying to like fit in and all that stuff, but he said he had that dark thought in his heart where he's like, I wonder if I met that woman again, that woman from 7 years ago. I wonder if I met her again. Would she give me that same look? Like, I don't think she would give me that same look this time. So Daigo became very
kind of... また、ああいう顔されたくないから、この地位を保たなきゃいけないって話になっちゃう。そのためには、周りの顔色をうかがって、そうですね、周りがある程度周りが言うように動いて、さっきの話で言えば強いキャラ使って、無難にやっていかなきゃいけない。So,
he realized, like, he's like, I won. Like, that woman looked down on me. Now I'm successful, so if I saw her again, she definitely wouldn't give me that look. Like, I am successful now, so I got my revenge. But then I realized, like, oh, I can't leave this position now. Like, I can't leave this position, right? I have to make sure that, like, people acknowledge me. He had that kind of, that sense of, like, oh, people need to acknowledge me. So he started to do things, act in a way that, like, the people around him, like, the surroundings, they would, instead of looking down on him, they would look up to him. So he said, kind of like, you could compare it to picking the strong character. right? Pick the strong character, like picking Guile, doing what's expected, doing what is considered strong instead of what he wanted to do.
うちの家の教えで、うちの親の教育ってシンプルなんですよ。
He said, my upbringing was really simple. Brush your teeth.
あとは、人のこと騙してまで、こう、なんていうのかな、こう自分を成功させようと思うなみたいな、こういうことも言われましたね。で、その中にもう一個、人に迷惑かけんなと。人に迷惑かけないんだったら、別に俺らはお前が何してようがいいよと、好きに生きろ、お前の人生だから。ただし人には迷惑かけんな。
So Daigo said his upbringing, compared to other people, his upbringing from his parents was really simple. It was like just really basic stuff. Brush your teeth, put your shoes away, like succeed, like whatever you do, do it well, like succeed in whatever you want to do. And don't cause, what is it? Like don't be a burden on anybody. Don't be a burden or don't trouble other people.
You know, that's why... 意識してましたね。人に迷惑かけないでどういうことなんだろうって、まああんまりね突き詰めて考えちゃうと生きてるだけで大から少なから迷惑かけちゃいますから、まあ常識の範囲内で迷惑をかけないってそういうことだろうなと勝手に理解して思ってたんだけど、でじゃあ話戻して周囲の期待に応えるっていうのは、いや言い方おかしいな、周囲の期待に応えない。
So out of those upbringing things, Daigo was thinking, he thought a lot about don't be a burden on others. Don't be a burden on others. So he said, no matter what you do, if you live your life and if you don't answer like the calls or the hopes of people around you, then that's going to be a burden on them, right? You're burdening people. Yeah, so for example, like that girl that I talked about earlier who chose like the lesser partner, she caused problems for her parents. Like she burdened her parents by choosing what she wanted to do. So right there, Daigo, that was kind of funny. So this is a business speech in front of a 300 businessmen and women, but Daigo said "ore," which is like the rough way of saying me. So the chat went Japanese chat went crazy here. Daigo's upbringing, he's from a place called Adachi, which is considered like a rough area, but they said his Adachi blood came out right there. So he said "ore," then he said, "Oh, sorry," he said, "Excuse me, I said ore." I meant boku.
かけるってことだと思わないですよ。周囲の期待って多分皆さんもありますよね。嫁の期待、親の期待、部下の期待なのか、上司の期待なのか、わからないけど、友達の期待なのか。そんなの知ったこっちゃないじゃないですか。勝手に期待すんなよって。大体期待って具体的じゃないんですよ。 どうなれば相手が満足するかって全然明確じゃない。ただなんとなくぼんやり期待してる。で相手を追い詰める。
All right, so he's saying, look, it's kind of hard. So the one thing was about not causing other people, not being a burden on other people. But he said, if you don't answer other people's hopes, then you're causing them a burden, like that girl did. But then Daigo says, well, it doesn't matter because it's everyone in the world has all sorts of different people having their hopes for you. It could be your partner, your parents, your friends, like your bosses, your fans, your neighbors. Like everyone you know is always hoping on you or wanting you to do something. They're expecting you to do something. But Daigo says, don't. He's like, well, they shouldn't, no one should be asking you to do anything. Like, no one should be expecting you to do anything. He's like, if you live and you're trying to answer everyone's hopes for you, first of all, they're not even clear, right? No one has a clear hope. Like, how can you make other people happy? It's not defined on how to make other people happy. Everyone just kind of has this vague idea of what they want you to do. So you don't know what you need to do to make them happy, right? It's always really vague. And then if you do it, they're going to go want something else from you. So it'll like never end, right?
で期待に応えて期待に応えて期待に応えて、yeah. で自分はあ人生つまんねえなって思うんですよ。
Yeah. So if all you're doing is answering other people's hopes for you, then you're gonna realize, wow, life is so boring. What am I doing with my life?
それが行き過ぎちゃうとね、最悪の場合自分で自分の人生終わらしちゃうなんてことだってあるわけですよね。
Yeah, and then if you, the worst case scenario, did he talk about killing yourself? I don't know. But he said in the worst case scenario, if you keep going, you keep following that, your own life will end. As in, I don't know, maybe. Your life, you just die. Like, you reach the end of your life and you spent your whole life trying to meet other people's expectations of you.
うちの親は、その、数少ない教育方針でしたけど、その中に人の期待に応えなさいっていうのはなかったですから。
So he said, my upbringing was really simple, but my parents never taught me as a child, like, one of the life lessons my parents told me, it was never, they never told me,answer other people's hopes for you or always meet other people's expectations. They never told him that.
人の期待にはどうやら答えなくていいらしい。まあちょっとね、あの、そう言うと何もしないやつだと思われるかもしれないけど、まあ僕の考えは、あなたたちの思う形では期待に応えませんよ。これが僕の生き方ですからね。
So Daigo said, all right.He said, so I was never raised this way, so I thought that it's fine. It's fine for me to never answer anyone else's expectations of what I want to do. He's like, wait a second, that might make it sound like I'm a lazy guy who doesn't do anything, but let me rephrase that. I will not meet people's expectations of what they think they want me to do. That's kind of hard to say. But like whatever image that people haveOf the way they want me to be, I'm never going to fit that image. I'm never going to meet their image. I'll meet their expectations through other ways, I think, is what he's implying.
あなたたちの想像の範囲で僕は期待には答えませんよ。
Yes.
僕は僕のやり方で期待に答えますよっていうのが。
Yes. So he said, yes. Whatever image you have in your head, I'm not going to do that. I will meet your hopes in my own way.Like, I will live up to your expectations in my own way, not in the path that you're choosing for me.
今の心境なんですよね。
That's his philosophy now.
あら、まあ、今日、その、皆さんに、どうしても言いたかったことっていうのは、まあ、勝ち続ける意志力とかね、一日一つだけなるって、まあ、もちろんそれも、現実世界は競争激しいですから、無視していいとは言いませんが、何のために勝つのか、何のために成長するのかということを忘れると、忘れるというか明確にしておかないと、つい数日前までの僕のように、なんで生きてんだっけなって、っていうことになっちゃう。だから、まあできる範囲で、まあ皆さんもちょっとこう自分の気持ちに正直に。これって自分が正しいと思い込んでたけど人に正しいと思い込まされてるだけなんじゃないのかなっていうことが一つや二つあると思いますからまあそれをこう可能な範囲で俺の好きなように生きるぜってやってもらえたらまあ今日講演した甲斐があるかなと思いますこんなとこですかね
いやいやいや
よろしいでしょうかすいませんじゃあはいどうもありがとうございました。
All right, so he said, so what I wanted to talk
about. これが僕の生き方ですからね。
One time.
あなたたちの想像の範囲で僕は期待には応えませんよ。僕は僕のやり方で期待に応えますよっていうのが、今の心境なんですよね。
So he said he went on like two big points at the end. So I'll do one and then the other one.
あら、まあ、今日、
so it's the first point.
皆さんに、 どうしても言いたかったことっていうのは、まあ勝ち続ける意志力とかね、一日一つだけになるって、まあもちろんそれも現実世界は競争激しいですから無視していいとは言いませんが、何のために勝つのか、何のために成長するのかっていうことを忘れると、忘れるというか明確にしておかないと、つい数日前までの僕のように、なんで生きてんだっけなって。
He's like, well, so to wrap things up, the thing that I wanted to tell everyone today, like my main point, the thing I want you guys to listen the most is, yes, of course, I was talking about how to improve and like earlier they talked about how to improve and all that. He's like, of course, I want to talk about that, and whether you use it or not, it's all up to you. It depends on your own situation. But I really wanted to make sure everyone knows that, or I want you all to realize and think of why. Like, why are you improving? Why are you doing this? He's like, if you lose sight of what you want, and if you lose sight of like what you want and why you're doing things, then you might end up like I was just a couple, like a little bit before, when I was very depressed and I was wondering, what's the point of living?
っていうことになっちゃう。だから、まあできる範囲で、まあ皆さんもちょっとこう自分の気持ちに正直に、これって自分が正しいと思い込んでたけど、人に正しいと思い込まされてるだけなんじゃないのかなっていうことが一つや二つあると思いますから。
So he says, I want everyone here to, I'm sure everyone here, I want you to directly look at yourself, and I want you to think that maybe there's something that you thought, you always thought was, this is correct, this is correct. You always thought this is right, or this is correct, or this is the way it is. But maybe this is something that you were forced to think because people around you influenced you and forced you to think that this is correct, or this is the way it should be. Daigo says, I'm sure that everyone has at least one or two things that you've been influenced. So he's like, I want you to think on your own, right? Think on your own without other people's influence or expectations, and you know, you choose and decide what's right.
まあそれをこう可能な範囲で俺の好きなように生きるぜってやってもらえたら、まあ今日講演した甲斐があるかなと思います。
So if you guys watching or you guys listening, if you can find one or two things that other people areYou've been influenced or you've been led on, and then you can decide, no, I'm going to do what I want to do. I'm going to live my way, my style. If anyone here can, this speech helped you out and you're able to do that, then I feel like this presentation I gave had some value, had some worth. So that's about it. Thank you very much.
こんなとこですかね。大体。よろしいでしょうか。
Is that okay?
すみません。じゃあ。
Thank you.
はい。どうもありがとうございました。
Thank you very much. Ta-da! Ta-da! All right, that's it.